WebSportsRadio.com, in association with KBFL, proudly presents Missouri State University Ice Hockey. With the call, here's Steve Kasson.
And live from Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton Ice Arena, it is game two between Missouri State and the Grand Canyon University Lopes. Hello, everybody. We have a packed crew tonight. Steve Kasson, Dan Dowell, Kurt Busson, Scott Lutzke on graphics. And it is game two between these two teams. And some interesting facts for yesterday's game, for those of you who may have missed it. But 17 different Ice Bears recorded a point in last night's game. Missouri State netted the most goals in a single game since January 25th, 2019, a win over the University of Missouri. Back then, they were a Division III team, and that was our annual Mizzou games, and it was Missouri State Division I versus the Division III. In fact, that was the last weekend series the Division I has played against Mizzou, since now they're in Division III. Our Division III team plays Mizzou. But there were a lot of similarities, including both teams were 3-0 after one period over the opponent. Both had only one power play goal, one goal for Missouri State. Both games ended 15-2, and Derek Smith was the only player to play in both games, although Bailey Stevens was a backup in the Mizzou game for the series, so technically two. And another interesting fact is that Missouri State has not lost a WCHL home game since November 22nd of 2019, 687 days.
Impressive.
Now, a little misnomer there because there were no WCHL games last season.
A little asterisk on that one, yes,
yeah.
But we won't talk about that. That's okay.
But regardless, a lot of things, and I've been told, knock on wood, you know, I've got to do the knock on wood thing because I'm talking about it. Dan Dell, I know that you've been keeping track of some of the games across the ACHA. One, I guess, is it a final? Is it an upset?
Not quite. Last I had checked, Utah was up 3-1 against, I believe UNLV's in the top five now, against UNLV. But early stages of the third, and as of right now, let me get a check here. Looks like it's actually tied now, 3-3. UNLV coming back.
Oh, wow.
Mid-third, so we've got an interesting game on our hands out in the desert in Las Vegas.
Now, Dan, one of the things that you did last season, or no, the last time you were kind of my camera guy, color guy, is I was amazed at how you could run camera, you could be my color guy, and you could look up scores at the same time.
That was a long, long time ago. I think I lost a good chunk of those skills, Steve.
So what did I do? I tried to use those skills tonight. At least you have me run camera tonight. I appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem.
But yesterday, Missouri State had a 15-2 victory, and as I mentioned, 14 different players scored. And you know, if we take a look at the highlights here, you know, Cody Flan getting the first goal, Gallant and Wheatop with the assist, and Missouri State just started to pour things on late-ish in the first period. A power play goal by Maltner, who had goals and assists galore in yesterday's game. Ross with two goals yesterday, along with Terrence Josephson. So a guy that actually had been held off the scoreboard a little bit, Terrence Josephson, finally gets a couple of goals. And in fact, goals wise, he is the leader for Missouri State with five goals. Coming up second, several players with three goals each, including Jacob Wheatop, Evan Ross, and Derek Smith with a pair yesterday too. So guys, with the scoring that Missouri State has, you can't really look at yesterday's 15-2 game and say, oh, this is a powerhouse team that's got a lot of scoring. There still is a lot of the season remaining to kind of weed that out.
Sure. You know, once they start piling up like that, everyone likes to jump in and get involved, and it's great to see, the typical stat patter, as they say. so you can't read a whole lot into that once those floodgates open. But hey, they're still pumping those goals in. Guys are getting on the board and doing their job. So that's great to see. And it's great to see so many, like you said, 17 different guys getting their name on the score sheet. Love to see balanced scoring like that. And several of those guys, I think at least one or two, got their first career Ice Bears goals last night. Is that right, Steve?
Several got their first one, including Louis Shakes, Tommy Raymer got their first. So, yeah, and McGowan also got his first. So it's nice to see that from some of the players that are new to the team. You know, but you look at this Grand Canyon Lopes team, and they had a lot of accolades in Division II. Now, they made it to Nationals. They clinched the top seed of the West Coast Hockey League playoffs for the first time and qualified for the regional tournament two in a row. And the only thing I can say is let's akin it to Missouri State, where the Ice Bears won several league tournaments. They made it to regionals, they made it to nationals, and decided to take that leap. But the Ice Bears had trouble the first season or so trying to feel their way through Division One, and Grand Canyon, who hoped to play last season, didn't because of COVID, and now maybe they're running through the same path as Missouri State.
Sure. And like you said, it's going to be lumps for any team that makes that jump up. And I still think, you know, we can't come out here today and just expect to roll in like 15-2 again. They were competitive up at Maryville and split earlier on with a solid team, a D2 team. And so they're certainly capable of playing better, I think. And I think we're going to see a better effort from them tonight. I think we've got to be ready for that and certainly not take the pedal off the gas at this point. You've got to come out with that same intensity and make sure we have our minds right as we come into this one, because you certainly don't want to let them hang around in this game. The longer it stays close, the more confidence you let them build. And I think we saw that last night when we finally started to chip away and build that lead. You know, we really kind of wore them down, and finally those floodgates opened, we were able to just start rolling. But it's going to be key to do that again tonight.
Grand Canyon will start once again Gabriel Lepper. And in three games, he's 0-1 with a 6.29 goals against average, 8.28 save percentage. But again, that's early on in the season, and you got to look at what happened yesterday. That changed his stats. Good goaltender.
Yeah, he made some really key saves early on. We had a couple breakaway opportunities that he was stellar on. And I mentioned last night, I don't really think you can fault the goaltenders a whole lot for the 15 goals on the board last night. You know, credit our guys with some snipes and some one-timers and just deflections that got through. So they do have solid goaltending. I don't think that's their issue. And I, again, just expect the Bears to come out with some good energy and keep peppering them with shots, and hopefully we'll see the same result tonight.
And let's not forget, guys, this is the first time that Grand Canyon isn't traveling the same day that they're playing a hockey game. They traveled up to Maryville and St. Louis on Thursday night, had to travel back down here for tomorrow's night's game, and finally was able to get some rest after last night. So I expect a better footing for the Lopes tonight as well.
Yeah, it's also the final game of a five-game road trip for the Lopes, which, by the way, it is going to be Scott Kazabowski in nets tonight. I mentioned Lepper, but Kazabowski will be in nets. In two games, he's 1-1 with a 4.57 goals against average, 8.52 save percentage. For Missouri State, Matt Griffin will be in net. And Griffin, in two games, he's 1-1 with a 3.0 goals against average and a 9.18 save percentage. So goaltenders who relatively... are seeing just their third. Just their third game this season for each team in game number two. The referees will be the same. Jason Carrera is the referee, or make the officials. Mark Marzola and Craig Ford are the linesmen. Same public address announcer, our general manager, Ryan Armstrong, will be doing the honors here momentarily. But let's join Ryan now.
The starters for Grand Canyon University from on left wing, number 89, Calum Tomlin. Starting at center, number 9, Matthew Mezick. Starting on right wing, number 91, Preston Larson. Starting at defense, number 12, Ty Schaefer. Starting at defense, number 7, Dylan Dent. And starting in net tonight for the Lopes, number 36, Scott Kososki. The Lopes are head coached by head coach Daniel Roy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the heart of Springfield, Missouri, inside the Jordan Valley Ice Park, and within the beautiful Stan Melton Arena, it's time. Everyone on your feet. Let's meet the starters for your Missouri State Ice Bears. Starting at left wing, from Macomb, Michigan, number 23, Garrett Wojcicki. Starting at center, from Peoria, Illinois, number 10, Jack Brackville. Starting at right wing, from St. Louis, Missouri, number 22, Jason Kelly. Starting at defense, from St. Peters, Missouri, number 25, Tommy Rammer. Starting at defense, from Royal Oak, Michigan, number 47, Jake Kopinski. And starting in net tonight for the Ice Bears, from Glen Carbon, Illinois, number 29, Matt Griffin. The Bears are head coach Jeremy Law, assistant coach Cliff Cook, and Josh Bell. Tonight's referees, Jason Carrera, Craig Ford, and Mark Crossbar Marzola. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Big crowd on hand here for Missouri State and Grand Canyon. Game two between these two teams. Missouri State coming in at 5-2, and Grand Canyon is 1-2-1 after yesterday's win by Missouri State. And boy, was it impressive if you missed the game. The Ice Bears with a 15-2 win yesterday. Ice Bears started out with three straight goals, and then after a Tomlin goal, Missouri State racked off another set of goals, about 10 or 11 or so. And I think a lot of that had to do, and we'll show it here when we have some time, but a lot of it had to do with the big hit on Brussa, and that changed things around for Missouri State. The Ice Bears skate from the left to the right. And from the right to the left, it'll be Grand Canyon. And quickly, the Lopes will have it. They give it up to Matthew Mezick. He will bring it as far as the Ice Bears line, and Missouri State returns the favor. Jack Brackville gets hacked as he slides around Tomlin. works through behind the net. Intercepted, though, and taken by Ty Schaefer. In four games, he has one assist for the Lopes. Puck is cleared out, and Jason Kelly has it for Missouri State. He'll have it with Brackbill. It will be Jack Brackbill, Jason Kelly, and Garrett Wojcicki tonight. Brackbill backhands it to Kelly off of his body, and Larson is able to clear it out to center ice. Preston Larson, one of 16 players to return from last season. When I say that, that's an asterisk because the Lopes were about to start the season and then COVID hit. Now getting tripped up in front is Shakes, and we're going to get a penalty. The first one will go to Messick, and Missouri State will go on the power play this quickly.
Yeah, loose puck in front, kind of a turnover in the Lopes zone. They're forced to take a man down. And great opportunity here for the Ice Bears to jump on him early in this first period with the power play.
The Ice Bears on the power play, seventh. They are 4 for 24, 16.7%. And actually, they're not seventh. That was last season. I had forgot to turn that stat off. So here come the Ice Bears hoping to turn it on with a goal. Frederick, right side. It gets blocked into the corner. Wheatop now to McGowan. We'll drop it down in low. Behind to Wheatop. Over to Kaysen Gallant. Gallant with it left side. He shoots, and a save by Kasabowski, and he'll hold on. 18:33 to go in the period, and 1:27 left in the power play. So the Ice Bears working it very well now.
Lots of good crisp puck movement and cycling that puck in the offensive zone, looking for a lane to get a feed across for an open man.
False face off, and we'll do it again.
Like to see that on the power play.
Brackbill in to take the draw, and he tried to win it from Potich, and off the draw, the Ice Bears corral it in the corner. Drop down low off of Ross's skate, works it to Brackbill, now back to Bratton. If that name sounds familiar, yes. His brother used to play here. Here's Brackbill. In low to Bratton. We'll work it around. But he's not playing on a beeline, though. I mean, kind of. He's got Brackbill. Here comes Ross. In front, he shoots, and a glove save. So it's two-thirds of another beeline.
It's a BRB line. It's a B-right back line.
There you go. Nice work movement behind the net. And through some traffic, Ross got a good shot. So Brackbill again. They work it to Raymer. Cross ice to Brussa. He shoots. It's partially blocked. Power play is 45. Bratton. Left side low along the left circle. Brussa. He shoots. Missed up high from the left side. Now to Raymer. Spun around to Brackbill behind the net. Schaefer trying to block in front for the Lopes. Ice Bears have it. Centering it in front. Drive and a big save as Ross was there. And a good save by Kasabowski. Ice Bears work it again. Power play is 21 seconds. Still trying to get someone in front. It's a backhander in front by Bratton, but it's covered up by Kasabowski.
Boy, great job there by Ross to just slide into that open spot, find a seam, and free himself for a pass and a shot. Teammate able to find him, get a good shot on goal, but a solid save by the Lopes goaltender.
17:20 to go in the first period. Wheatop and Donovan in to take the draw. The Ice Bears win it. Wheatop has. Puck is taken away, though. It's cleared. That should do it for the power play. Four to go. And by the time Missouri State gets things set up, if they get things set up, Messick out of the box. And it's sent right back in by Anthony Petroto. Petroto, three games. One goal and two assists. Puck comes right up the middle in front of Bailey, or in front of Matt Griffin. Now here comes Wheatop for the Ice Bears. Centered in front to Gallant. Score! Kaysen Gallant will get goal number five, and Missouri State takes a 1-0 lead. I will give you a hint. he is one of the players I'm going to interview at the first intermission. So, of course, he scores. And Missouri State has the 1-0 advantage.
Beautiful teamwork there. Great hustle down the right wing as he works it into the corner and finds his teammate open in the front and crashing the net. Gallant, great job there. Heads up play, and he buries the one-timer. And just after the power play had expired, Bears able to break, or the Ice Bears able to break through and lead this one 1-0.
So Gallant will get the goal, and we get an icing called here. But Missouri State takes the advantage. Just a nice bang-bang play from behind the net. We'll catch the call from public address announcer.
Ice Bears goal scored by number 74, Jacob Wheatop. Assist on the play to number 3, Sam Frederick. Time of the goal, 3:16 of the first period. 74 assisted by 3. That's a Missouri.
Okay. I have no idea. We'll have to see the next replay again and double check.
The pass came from 74 behind the net, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. So how could he score the goal? I have no idea how that happened. Meanwhile, the puck is cleared out to center. And that did not deceive my eyes. Dan, you're the cameraman. What do you think?
90 from 74.
Okay, that works for me. As he's doing double duty, that's the best he could say. Puck is cleared all the way down and a line change for Missouri State. So that will definitely have to be. We're going to go with Gallant from Jacob Wheatop. Ice Bears will keep it in the zone. They work it up the middle and Kelly will send it through. Deflected by Schaefer. Now a drive in from the left side by Brussa is held on to by Kazabowski. Let's see if we can take a look at that again. I was going to say, yeah, full screen will give us a really good look at this. So there's Wheatop. Oh, yeah. Definitely Gallant's goal. That'll definitely be changed. Meanwhile, off the draw, it'll be Tomlin. Sends it up to Messick for the Lopes. Trying to move around Brussa. Ice Bears have it. They have a 1-on-2 as a couple catch up. Here comes Wojcicki. Sends it over to Kelly. He shoots and said it scores! Jason Kelly will get credit for the goal, but unfortunately it tipped off the defense of Cameron Nealon and into the net, and Missouri State has a 2-0 lead. And for Jason Kelly, that is his first goal this season with Missouri State. He was looking to pass, and unfortunately the defenseman tipped it in, and Missouri State not only 5 minutes into this game has a 2-0 lead. Meanwhile, play is in the Missouri State zone to the right of Griffin. Let's catch the call.
By number 27, Derek Smith. Assist on the play to number 23, Garrett Wojcicki.
I don't know what's
going on. And by number 20, Noah Brussa.
Scores here.
Time of that goal, 5:02 of the first period.
Okay.
Apparently we're watching a different game than the referee is.
Apparently, I know you're supposed to go with what the officials say, but we're going to give this to Kelly, and we'll hopefully we can take a look at this one more time at the next stoppage, but we know it's Kelly's goal.
Oh.
Shot score! It tipped in, possibly. The initial shot came from Leif Murphy.
That one definitely looked like it changed direction on its way to the net. Great job there. Hand-eye coordination from the forward down low to deflect it. And not much the Ice Bears goaltender could do on that one.
Looks like Donovan will get credit for the goal. Here's Murphy's shot, and Donovan deflects it in.
So life for the Lopes as they're able to cut this deficit in half early in this first period still. We're not even 6 minutes into this game yet.
Now let's see if they call it Donovan with the assist to Murphy. Here in the first period. Here's Caden Hintz for Missouri State. He'll send it
in. Grand Canyon goal scored by number 17, Colby Donovan. Assisted by number 92, Leif Murphy. And by number 33, Jacob Cummings. Time of that goal, 5:33 of the first period.
Well, they got that one right. But we know there'll be a lot of changes. Especially since Derek Smith was actually on the bench. I have no idea how he could have scored that goal. A nice long 200-foot stick. Shot comes right in, safe. Rebound loose. Oh, what a huge save. The initial shot came from Raymer, and the goaltender, Kazabowski, slid across to make the save as right on the doorstep was Flan. Behind the net. Flan is there. He'll try to work it. Dent tried to take a dent into Flan, but he's able to move away. Was Cody. Comes right up the middle, and it is cleared by Dunick, and it's all the way out. Ice Bears catch the Lopes on a line change. Here's Gallant. He'll stop. Wait. Blocked by Schaefer, and he'll clear it. Here might be a break. No, it's not, because the Ice Bears, Sam Frederick, intercepts the pass. Battle for it. Meanwhile, Gallant will have it. He'll come in. Nice move. Gallant with it. Backhander out in front. And saved by the goaltender as Wietop came right through. Now, I believe this one's going to be the initial goal call, correct? Oh, that's the almost one. Okay. So we technically lost that replay is what you're saying for right now until we can get it back at intermission. But we know that it was Kelly's goal. Buck back in. Tomlin is there, but the Ice Bears roll. It's 2-1 in favor of Missouri State. Shots are 8-3. So it's been a flurry of goals, but it's been an answer back by the Lopes. Ice Bears with Derek Smith on the ice now. He leads it ahead, trying to get Matt McGowan, but instead it will be Petroto. Anthony Petroto out of Phoenix, Arizona. Buck sent ahead off of the stick of Preston Larson. And back down. Puck across the Lopes line. Now it's Ross. Had two goals in yesterday's game. Avoids a hit to McGowan with a drive that's fluttered over to the far side. Ice Bears with Wojcicki. Brussa keeps it in. Wojcicki handles it through. Now Nealon, who tipped in Kelly's goal earlier, handles the puck. Misek with it. It's out to center, and Brussa will set things up defensively for Levi Wright, the sophomore defenseman. He'll send it in all the way down, and the icing's been waved off. Wait.
Heard a whistle.
I heard a whistle, and the official waved it off, and now they stop play. Now there's the whistle. And they're gonna go to center ice with this.
Linesman Ford was indicating the puck would be dropped in the zone, but referee Carrera says otherwise. Marzola out there as well, as they'll bring it back out to center ice. Call it neutral, and
which is fair because one said no, one said yes. Brussa quickly gets it up to Kelly. Off of his stick, now to Brackbell. Two on one. Brackbell, he shoots, he scores! .951 will be the time of the goal for Jack Brackbell, who gets goal number two for Missouri State. It is 3-1 Ice Bears.
Just a great job there. Great decision by Jack as he looks across and sees that his teammate, the pass really wasn't there. I think he thought about it, but pass wasn't there on the two-on-one. Decides to take a shot, and it was the right decision as he beats the goaltender And Ice Bears reclaim their two-goal lead here.
We'll catch the call, and let's see if it's right. But the Ice Bears, now not even midway through this game, have a three, or through
this
period.
Missouri State goal scored by number 10, Jack Brackbell. Assist on the play to number 22, Jason Kelly. Time of the goal, 9:51 of the first period.
Meanwhile, players having a little extracurriculars. And I think it's Derek Smith who was tied up for Missouri State.
Yeah, a little pushing and shoving after the play there.
And for the Lopes, as you can see now.
Looks like we will have penalties.
Getting tied up is Jacob Cummings. Let's see what the penalties are. Smith goes in with Cummings.
Could be a offsetting penalty situation here.
Dan, be prepared. It's going to get a little crazy, probably. And it looks like they will be non-board setting penalties, so probably minors. Meanwhile, off the boards and off the draw, Gallant with it, and a pass through to Wietop doesn't connect. Comes to the right side. Wietop with it, trying to center it through. A trio of Lopes trying to prevent that. Near side. Comes up high. Here's Raymer. Score! Tommy Raymer with his second goal in a row for Missouri State. And Missouri State has a 4-1 advantage. Not even 10 minutes into this period.
Boy, as a defenseman, when that puck trickles out to you at the point and you see all that open ice, you're licking your chops, and that's exactly what Tommy Raymer was doing there. As he saw all kinds of open ice, just steps up and steps into one. Makes no mistake about that one and buries it. 4-1 Ice Bears.
10th shot for Missouri State.
Ice Bears goal scored by number 25, Tommy Raymer. Assist on the play to number 21, Cody Flan. Time of that goal, 9:41 of the first period. On the previous play, penalty to Grand Canyon number 33, Jacob Cummings, and to Missouri State number 27, Derek Smith. Both 10-minute misconducts. Time of those penalties, 9:13 of the first period.
So they both get 10.
That's another
Missouri State. Ice Bears. And the Ice Bears lose a forward. Far side, here's Sam Frederick out of North Vancouver, BC. Puck is flipped up and out and all the way down into the Lope zone. Quickly, they get it up. Misek with it, he shoots and a save by Griffin. He'll hold on. So they are coming fast and furious again.
Still the first period and we are just one goal away from another $1 Andy's treat this weekend, which we cashed in on last night, of course, with the 15 goals on the board. Just the one, we didn't get the three as we had hoped for, but we'll take one.
Off the draw, play is behind the Missouri State net. Taken away by Evan Ross across the line. Here's Ross right side, looking in front with a drive and a save. Rebound followed up is missed wide by McGowan. Behind the net to Bratton. Brassa left side, right side to right, W-R-I-G-H-T. Now here is Bratton as it sails right through. Moore is able to tip it away for the Lopes, and it's out to center. Getting around everybody is Rudick. But the Ice Bears regain possession in their own zone. 11-4 the shots, 4-1 Missouri State. Gallant, Kelly, Brackville, and Raymer.
Oh my.
And what a big save there.
Unbelievable save as that Puck was intercepted in the Ice Bear zone. Two Lopes, point blank range in front of the net. Pass across and heads up play there to try to go to his backhand. And just an unbelievable save, as you mentioned, Steve.
Got the paddle of the stick down. And Missouri State, thanking their lucky stars, they still have a 4-1 lead.
Yeah, without a doubt, Griffin's best save of this game so far.
Play is underway. The Ice Bears have it. It is cleared to the line, and the red line, that is, as it's out. Kelly couldn't pick it up. Raymer couldn't either. Puck back in the Missouri State zone. Jake Kopinski, the assistant captain for Missouri State. He'll try to work the puck. At center now. And it'll be Schaefer for the Lopes to send it to the Missouri State line. 14 different players scored in yesterday's contest. This game right now, it has been four different scores for Missouri State. Gallant, Kelly, Brackbill, and Raymer. 4-1, 7:37 to go in period one.
Had a lot of action in this one so far, and only about midway through this period, I guess we're...
Folks getting their money's worth.
Yes.
Far side, and they're one away from an Andes. Dollar Andes, that is. Here's Donovan. Brings it all the way across. Colby Donovan out of Loveland, Colorado, the sophomore forward. Ice Bears have it quickly, trying to catch Grand Valley in a line change. They'll send it in, and it'll be Wojcicki to put pressure. Missouri State finishes their line change. Louis Shakes on the ice now. Shakes will work it with Garrett Wojcicki, although Wojcicki comes off. Sent all the way down. We're going to get an icing call. 6:53 remains, and Missouri State will face it off or have it faced off in their own zone. And again, Kaysen Gallant will be our first period intermission guest. We hope you'll tune in for that. I will say, not that they all are not, but especially Gallant and Caden Hintz, my interviewees today, really good interviews today. Face-off is won. It's kicked out to center. And here comes Frederick. Leads the 4-on-4. Oh, a big hit there as Denick put one on an Ice Bear. Witter behind the net. Sends it over to the corner to Raymer. Drop down in low. Here's a shot in. Save by Kazabowski. He'll hold on. So we will probably have to get some score changes.
We had a similar situation last night on a goal that we questioned the scoring on. Was that one ever changed, Steve, from last night?
It actually was changed, yes. And I think you're talking about the goal that Wetop had at 10:17 to the third, and they did change it to Wetop.
So I would assume they'll probably do the same thing here tonight as they investigate that a little further.
Yeah, I'm assuming we will know after the first period that they have been changed. Play in the Missouri State zone. A couple of players fall down, including Shakes, near side. And Missouri State is able, with Caden Hintz's pass, to clear it out to center. Shakes putting a hit on. Now Shakes. Oh, he get hit from behind by Tomlin. And let's hope Shakes is okay.
Yeah, another penalty being called on the Lopes in the classic case of the retaliation being caught. Shakes going in, throwing his weight around.
So they're gonna get Shakes.
He's going to go too, okay.
Yeah, they're going to get Shakes, which, okay, fine. If he gets pushed into his own bench, what is he going to do?
Yeah, he was definitely coming in aggressive on the initial part of that play, maybe just a little bit after the play, so... Referee will send them both off, and we'll see if they're going to go coincidental minors again and cancel each other out 5-on-5, or if we'll see them on the board. Last time we had the 10-minute misconducts, which is why we didn't have the penalties on the board.
I would think a late hit would warrant something on the board, but apparently not.
Might just be 2 minutes each. Well, we're going to get a...
I think we're going to get... Well, it's hard to say. I don't know if it's just because of the period or if it's a check from behind and a disqualification or a game ejection. I don't know.
It didn't look overly gratuitous.
Nobody had his back to him, though.
Yeah.
And that's the key.
Yeah.
So I don't know. The officials are talking about it. Well, they're waiting for the referee, Jason Carrera, to finish up discussing things. So Shakes is on the board with 2 minutes. Not sure I get this unless...
Oh,
yeah, we do get
board.
The five. That's what I thought, a five, and it's probably a game misconduct.
So it looks like we'll skate five on five or four on four for the next 2 minutes, and the Ice Bears will get a 3 minute power play, major power play, so they can score as many times as they can.
Hopefully we'll get...
On the play to Grand Canyon number 89, Callum Tomlin. 5 minute major for unsportsmanlike conduct and a game disqualification. Penalty to Missouri State number 9, Lewis Shakes. 2 minutes for cross checking. Time of those penalties, 14:12.
Meanwhile, there is a delayed penalty upcoming, and it is touched by Missouri State, so that means it's a penalty against the Ice Bears. Cody Flan will go, and all of a sudden that major penalty time looks like, barring any further penalties, it's going away.
Yeah, it'll be a 4-on-3 opportunity now for the Lopes, as boarding is the call. And face-off back in the Ice Bears zone, so opportunity here for the Lopes to chip away at this lead.
Puck is cleared to back all the way down into the Lopes zone. So if you collect all the penalties, 3 minutes, or three penalties, 14 minutes for Missouri State, four penalties, 25 minutes for the Lopes, if you count the 15 that was given to Tomlin. The game misconduct counts as 10, and the 5 minute major, of course, 5 for 15. Meanwhile, it is a power play now. It's a shot that comes in that is saved by Griffin, but this power play is with quite a few less folks on the ice.
Yeah, 4-on-3 power play is always a dangerous one, as you said. Less people out there, more room to free people up and work the puck on the perimeter. And I just always felt like the 4-on-3 was an opportunity to work the puck a little better.
In 51 seconds, it'll be a 4-on-4 as the Ice Bears will get Shakes back. And what this means is, barring any further penalties, it's possible we could get back to 5-on-5. Across the line, Misek taken away and cleared immediately by the Ice Bears and sent all the way down.
Yeah, the Ice Bears should have a little bit of time left on the 5 minute major, as they'll get their two men back and actually go to work on the power play for a bit here in 46 seconds.
Here's Stewart across the line, a shot in that's deflected into the corner. 4 minutes to go, drive in is deflected away as Petroto got that one. Big pad save there. Now working the power play for another 4 seconds. Now it is a 4-on-4 for 26 seconds, and then the Ice Bears are back as we get a stoppage in play here to about 2.5 minutes or so of a 5 minute major. The good thing is they're coincidental.
Goaltender Griffin doing a great job of picking up pucks in the Ice Bears zone. Traffic in front of the net, but he's able to slide across and see it all the way, able to make that stop as the Lopes continue to put pucks on him.
3:42 to go, 4-1 Missouri State. Now in 16 seconds, the Ice Bears will go from a 4-on-4 to a 5-on-4, and they will get Cody Flann out. Missouri State with Frederick sends it into the zone, and now the Ice Bears have the 5-minute major, or the remainder of it, to work. Frederick down in low, gets it over to Wheatop, but it's too far for him and cleared out the center and all the way down. Now the Ice Bears working on the 5-minute major. This is power play number 2. After all is said and done, Cody Flann up to center off of McGowan and through to Gallant. Gallant with it. Works around the stick check of Schaefer of the Lopes. Gallant brings it up high. Sends it now to Flann left side. Back to Gallant after a skate check. Gallant with it. Through, gets pulled down. Penalty. Ice Bears are going to get the goaltender out. Flann will work it. He lets it get touched up. They don't want to. Finally, it does. And a hooking call will give Missouri State a 2-man advantage for 1:45.
Yeah, great work in the zone, just hustling on the puck and earned that penalty as he's taken down on the play. Huge opportunity here for the Ice Bears.
.233 to go in Missouri State with a golden opportunity. Brackbell and Petroto, and Brackbell wins it. Brussa to Raymer. Back to Brussa, left side. Looking to Raymer, they crisscross. Down in low to Bratton. He'll work the puck. Looking for someone in front, it's Ross. But instead, Brussa. Now a shot that's blocked. Brussa will keep it in play. Left side is Brussa. Down in low, and a shot that is deflected by the goaltender, Kazabowski, and it's cleared.
Bad break there as the Ice Bears were working the puck, but just a little bouncer hit a bad patch of ice and bounced over the stick. Lopes able to clear it out.
Ice Bears now with Bratton. Works it around, 2-man advantage for 1 minute. Bratton looking right side and left side. Raymer score again! Second in a row for Tommy Raymer, and Missouri State on a power play goal. This will cancel out the 1:10 that was left. So Missouri State 2-for-1 on the power play.
And just like his first goal, similar there, had open ice to skate that puck up, saw a lane and took advantage of it, steps up and buries it once again. Heads up play there by Tommy Raymer. 5-1 now, and officially Andy's time here at Jordan Valley Ice Park.
Definitely an Andy's frozen custard as you take a look at it, but the Ice Bears will work it again. They bring it across the line to
Missouri Gallant. State goal scored by number 25, Tommy Raymer. Assist on the play to number 15, Jared Bratton. And number 10, Jack Brackville. Time of that power play goal, 19:17 of the first period. 25 assisted from 15 and 10.
As he mentioned, it is a power play goal. And Missouri State is now working on power play number 3. Faceoff is coming outside the zone.
I feel like this is the longest first period ever. We've been minute 20 to go still here in the first period, but it has been a long one. Lots of action, lots of goals, lots of penalties.
Here's Wheatop, down in low, getting around Petroto. McGowan comes in to help out. And the Ice Bears to Frederick. Power play is 15. Shot in, it's blocked. Gallant save, rebound, score! McGowan! Missouri State is 2-for-3 on the power play. McGowan will get the goal. And the Ice Bears with 1 minute exactly left, still have the power play. It's on the 5 minute major.
And again, the Ice Bears doing great work in the zone, finding that man in the high slot, gets the shot off, and the rebound was right there, able to be banged home.
We'll catch the call from public address announcer Ryan Armstrong, but the power play has now expired.
Teams
and Missouri
are at
State
full strength.
Has scored two on the major.
Missouri State goal scored by number 18, Matt McGowan. Assists on the play to number 90, Kaysen Gallant. And to number 3, Sam Frederick. Time of that goal, 19 minutes of the first period. That's a Missouri State.
So the Ice Bears with a 6-1 lead on McGowan's second of the season. And, okay, true or false? Am I going to interview McGowan in the second period intermission? All the guys that I interview, they usually score. And actually not, that's false. It's Caden Hintz who will be my second period intermission. But Kaysen Gallant will be coming up in about 18 seconds.
Well, he's clearly waiting for the second period to score Hintz, right? So he can lead right into it.
Absolutely. Because McGowan was yesterday. Now with 5 seconds remaining. And that should do it for the first period of play. But an excellent period for Missouri State. The Ice Bears get 6 goals in this period. Gallant, his 5th. Kelly, his 1st. Brackbill, his 2nd. Raymer gets his 2nd and 3rd, 2 in the game, including a power play goal at 19:17. McGowan, his 2nd on a power play at 19 minutes. 6-1 Missouri State. Donovan, though, for Grand Canyon at 5:33, his 1st. And that's where we are after one period of play. Ice Bears are 2-for-3 on the power play. The Lopes are 0-for-1. Shots on goal in the period. Missouri State puts 17 on Scott Kazabowski. And Matt Griffin of Missouri State faces just 8 shots in the period by the Lopes. Dan Dale, you saw this period. You videotaped this period. What do you think?
I think Kurt really hit the nail on the head earlier in the period with the defenseman from Missouri State chomping at the bit at the blue line, keeping pucks in. We saw that quite a bit last night, and that's what I was really impressed with the most from the Ice Bears defensemen the last couple of nights is their ability to keep the puck in the offensive zone, the ability to keep the offensive zone pressure, and the ability to score off of that, off of those plays. We saw that last night with the huge bursts of the 6 goals in the second and third period. Third consecutive period for Missouri State with 6 goals for the Ice Bears.
Well, Missouri State, with the exception of Raymer getting 2, have had different scorers scoring a lot. I don't know if it's just this game, but to have different players scoring the way that they've had is a positive coming into next week with Central Oklahoma.
When I feel like we kind of talked about this the first weekend against Illinois State, there's quite a few players that are new to the roster, at least the Division I roster for Missouri State, whether it's incoming freshmen or promotion from Division III. But it's great to see the capacity at which they're scoring. You're getting production from up and down the line. That, and we talked about that in the pregame show as well. You get points from 18 of the 19 skaters for the forwards for Missouri State, and only 2 players on the ice that actually didn't get a point last night. So it's great to see the point production from all around.
Missouri State with a 6-1 advantage after one period of play. We'll take a break, and our guest will be Kaysen Gallant coming up in just a moment. After 20, 5-goal advantage for Missouri State. We'll be back.
Pearson Kelly Office Products presents
Great Moments in Office Technology.
When Julie gets bored at work, she writes funny captions to pictures of animals she found online. Then she realized she could send all of her pictures in one gigantic message to her coworkers. At that moment, Julie created Junk Email. Now, employees can enjoy their days watching auto-tuned sneezing pandas. There are plenty of ways to waste your company's money. Your copier shouldn't be one of them. Pearson Kelly Office Products. Business made simple.
We are back at Jordan Valley Ice Park. Steve Kasten now talking with a man that leads the league, at least the league. I wish he did. No, he leads the team in scoring. Kasten Gallant, 4 goals, 4 assists out of Red Deer, Alberta, Canada. I just prepped you. You're leading the league. Maybe you are. I don't know. But you're putting the puck in the net, that's for sure. And, of course, you're only a freshman. Are you seeing everything well on the ice right now?
You know, it's different for sure. I mean, like, I haven't played with, you know, COVID and stuff. I hadn't played in, like, a year and a half. So it was different to come out and try and get all those legs back. There's a lot of rust that had to be shaken off. But I felt I'm starting to feel better every game. So it's, you know, and I'm playing with some good guys. I got Flanner on my line and Wheatop. And, you know, we playing with Cooley, too. You know, they know how to move the puck well. And so I just got to find the right area for them.
Yeah, hopefully we'll get Cooley back here pretty soon.
Yeah.
But, you know, one of the things I noticed was after game one, it felt like for game one, like you said, it just get a little bit of rust off, and it was like riding a bike, because then all of a sudden, I mean, you were blasting pucks from the point and things were going in. And I remember your first goal, you kind of, wow, I got a goal. That's awesome.
Yeah.
So did that kind of throw you off?
It did a little bit for sure. I mean, that game, I was a little frustrated. I thought I could have had one sooner, but I mean, it happens, and it's a game of mistakes. So, but it went in, and I was really thankful it did, because it was a good way to, you know, get the monkey off my back of a year and a half. So it felt good to, and it was good to get the boys going and, you know, have that one under my belt.
Kasten Gallant is joining us. What made you decide Missouri State?
Well, Missouri State, like, I was in Kelowna, BC, and my coach was Ken Law, and his son is Jeremy. So we kind of got in contact in my last 20 year season there or whatever. And so we started chatting up. He offered me a contract. And I originally didn't actually choose here. I chose a school in Alberta. And then I changed my mind. I decided, you know what, I want to get out of Canada and see what it's like. I'd never left the country before. So and I'm glad I came. It's awesome.
I was going to say, what is it like being here at Missouri State?
It's a lot different for sure. I mean, like I said, I haven't gone to school in a while either. So, I mean, it was awesome to come here, and the guys are great. It's a similar size to my hometown. My hometown's about 110,000 people, I think. Here is a little more, but it's definitely similar. A lot flat, too. No, nothing like BC where there's lots of mountains or anything like that.
And not a lot of snow either, right?
No, and I do like the snow. I do like the cold.
Well, I don't wish it on everybody here. We're kind of used to maybe about a week or two of snow, and that's it. But
yeah.
Trust me, I miss it, too. I'd love to go. Plus, you've been probably out on a bunch of frozen lakes playing out.
Yeah.
So it's...
Yeah, I miss that the most, probably. This winter is going to be tough not being able to go to the outdoor rinks and on those lakes and stuff and playing with my buddies and just kind of having a good time and relaxing and playing some hockey.
Here at Missouri State, it is a little bit different, like you mentioned. Because of the fact, especially through juniors, all you're concerned about is playing.
Yeah.
And you're really concerned about staying on that team.
Mm-hmm.
Here it's different. I mean, you're on the team. You're not going to go anywhere. They're not trading you.
Yeah.
But now all of a sudden, you've got school to worry about. How do you juggle the two?
I found that I had to build a schedule. I found, like, in Kelowna, like, we had a full-on schedule built for us just for the team stuff, and I felt that I worked best like that. So I built myself a schedule from, you know, whether it's my classes at 9, I'll get up at 8 and make breakfast and go from there, and class till noon, and then do homework for a couple hours and then go to practice. And I found that if I build a schedule for it, I can follow it. And if I just do it nonchalantly and I go, oh, I have time here, then I find I always just kind of don't really get into it as much.
For the freshmen, they're giving them a break, so to speak, that your first semester, you're okay to screw up, so to speak.
Yeah.
You don't want to take advantage of that, do you?
I don't. I really don't. I mean, I'm really trying my heart out to just do as well as I can. I've never been a super book smart guy, but I always thought I could just coast through it. So now I'm excited to get some really good grades and hopefully, you know, push into my degree.
Yesterday was really a crazy game.
It was, yeah.
Is that about as crazy as you've been a part of?
Probably since, like, novice. I think the biggest scoring game I ever was in was like 22-2. So that was definitely a close one. It's been a long time since I've been in a game like that.
What are some of the things that you want to accomplish hockey-wise?
hockey-wise, I would love to play here for my, you know, 4 or 5 years or whatever, and then I want to go play pro hockey at some point. That's kind of where I want to, somewhere over in Europe maybe, Division 3, 2, maybe even 1 if I can get there. But I got a long ways to go, and I know that, so I'm excited for that road.
Kason Vallon is joining us. So you do, of course, want to finish your studies, get that going. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Well, I don't know. I guess I wanted to be something always in sports, something maybe like exercise movement, like kinesiology, something like that. Sports have always intrigued me, the movement of it all and the mental side of it, too. I'd really like to learn about that, so even psychology and stuff like that, maybe.
Well, you know, we have a former player and coach that now is on the Blues.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah, that's awesome for him. That's a great achievement for that guy.
Of course, talking about former player and coach for about a half a season, and Brendan McClue. That gives you some kind of hope, right?
It does. It really does. It's good to see some guys progressing like that and actually, you know, making a name for themselves in the hockey world.
Kason Gallant is joining us on Missouri State, the forward out of Red Deer, Alberta, Canada, freshman, 5'11", 170. Little misleading there.
A little bit.
When you look at those stats.
Yeah, a little bit. I'm not a huge big guy, but I like to use my speed over my strengths or my muscles, so I find that's always worked for me.
How different is playing in Canada versus playing in the United States? Is there a difference?
There's nothing too crazy. It's definitely, there's definitely a little bit of a difference, just the way that the fundamentals are. There's a couple different rules that are different, so I can't name any off the top of my head, but I know that I've sat there on the bench and gone, like, oh, what the heck is he calling there or something like that, but, you know, it's similar. It's still the game of hockey, so you just kind of have to learn how to play with other players, so.
Do you remember the first time you were ever on skates?
Oh, I think, no, I remember my first year, though. I was never, so like in novice, they would blow the whistle down or whatever, and all the players would skate out of the bench, and if you were the first or the fastest skater, you got to be a forward. And I was never the fastest skater, and I'd crawl my way to defense, and I'd sit there and play defense and block shots. So that was probably my earliest memory of hockey, and you know, I kind of fell in love with it that year, and I scored 2 whole goals that year, and I fell in love with it.
Is there a moment in your playing career, a game or a situation that you will remember wholeheartedly?
Wholeheartedly, I'll remember I was in Kelowna my second year. It was our general manager had passed away, and our home opener was for him, and so we had about 1,000 people in the rink, and most people I've ever played in front of in Kelowna. We went to double overtime, and I was fortunate enough to score that goal for him. And you know, that feeling was amazing. You know, the team was so bonded. We wore his name on our name bars, and you know, that was probably the one that's going to stick with me the most. That it meant the most to me.
Now you do realize you'll be playing in front of more than 1,000 people here at Jordan Valley, right?
Yeah.
And you may have already done that. I know our home opener was pretty packed, but when teams like Lindenwood and UCO come in, especially next weekend,
yeah,
just get ready.
I will be.
For such a small building, too. Now, the question is, have you ever been blown away by a horn every time you guys score like you do here?
I don't think I have. I think there's been like a little one, but nothing like this. This one's crazy, right? This one's awesome. I love this one.
See, I set that up. It was perfect, wasn't it? Kason Gallant is joining us of Missouri State, the forward out of Red Deer, Alberta, Canada. Brothers and sisters?
Yeah, I've got 3 little brothers and an older sister.
Now, the next key is don't talk over the horn. I've already figured that one out. But say that again.
I got 3 little brothers and an older sister.
Do they play hockey?
My little brothers used to. My sister never did. She'd come to the games and watch, and you know, she'd be voluntold to come watch. But my little brothers, they played for a little while, and then they stopped playing. And then my youngest one, he's kind of getting back into it, and so it's kind of fun to take him out to the rink sometimes.
So it's fair to say that you're kind of the highlight of the family right now?
In hockey, I guess you could say that, I guess, yeah.
What happened, like, when you started growing up? I know with Canada, you could be spread all over. You know, 1 week you're playing 200 miles this way, next week you're playing 200 miles the next way. I don't know how many in Red Deer, how many teams there are locally, but was there ever a situation where pretty much your family had to decide, okay, are we going here or are we going there?
No, we never did. Thankfully, there was a pretty big age gap for the family, so it wasn't too bad. So when I had to do traveling, either my mom could take me or I'd catch a ride with some teammates, or my dad would show up and he'd come pick me up. So, you know, it was never like that. It was never too crazy. They always made it work, and I was very thankful that, you know, that for every sacrifice they made, and it was awesome that they did that for me. And I wouldn't be here without them. So,
Cason Gallant is joining us. And you mentioned that, you know, Hunter Cooley is on a line with you. And then you also have Jacob Wietop and Cody Flan, who now you're playing with now. Is it just kind of a situation where it doesn't matter who you're playing with, that everyone gels?
I think, honestly, like now we're finding that team that whole team chemistry. So if you put anyone on any line, I think they're just going to figure out a way to play with each other. And you know what, the speed picks up, and you guys figure out. You guys talk a little bit more, and you learn where they're going to be. And it's kind of nice to be able to do that.
A couple of quick things. First of all, who's the best chirper on the team?
Oh goodness, I don't know. I'd probably say Terry. Terry's pretty beaky in the room, like Josephson. He's good in the room though. I like him. He's a little quieter out on the ice, I think, but in the room he's got some good ones.
Okay. Who's the best dressed?
Ooh. You know what? I probably have to say Louis. He's always got a hat on. You know, that's a good style point for sure.
And one last question. Who has a twig? And for those who don't know, it's a hockey stick, but who has a twig that you really wish you had right now?
Oh, maybe Jacob Wietop. He's got a pretty neat one. It's got like five sides on it. It's like a hexagon. I don't know. It'd be pretty neat to try. I was pretty fortunate. I got to try a lot of sticks when I was in Kelowna. So, I mean, there's not too many I haven't tried and I didn't really like. So, I mean, those ones were pretty sweet, though.
Okay, this one's specifically for head coach Jeremy Law. What was it like to be coached by his dad?
It was good. He's actually an amazing, phenomenal coach, you know. Him and I, you know, we didn't always agree, but that's okay. He's the coach, and I wasn't, I'm not the coach. I was just a player, and he saw things that I could never see, and he built amazing teams that I got to play for, and so that was awesome.
Cason Gallant is joining us. Cason, at the end of interviews, I always wish players good luck and more goals. Everybody I've ever interviewed has always scored during the weekend, so I hope that happens for you. And again, good luck for the rest of the season.
I'll see what I can do. Thank you very much for having me.
Well, thanks for doing this. We'll take a break. Be back. More hockey coming up in a moment.
Hey, Missouri. Barrel Bob here. I'm MoDOT's Work Zone Spokesbarrel. I see a lot of distracted drivers in work zones not paying attention to the road. Distracted driving is the number one cause of crashes. The average text takes 5 seconds to read. At 55 miles per hour, you could travel the length of a football field blindfolded. Don't take the chance. I want you and my friends working on the roads to get home safely. Please buckle up and put your phone down. A message from the Missouri Department of Transportation.
Hey, Springfield, are you ready for some hockey?
Here's Barrett.
Left side with a V-line on over to O'Brien. Back to Barrett. Score!
Steve Kasson here, voice of your Missouri State Ice Bears. Join us at Jordan Valley Ice Park in downtown Springfield for this year's excitement.
This is head coach Jeremy Law. The Bears are back for another season, so check out our schedule at MissouriStateHockey.com and get your tickets now.
Here come the Ice Bears. Turin with Bell catching up. Turin should score! Oh, baby! Your best source for awards of any kind is always Bowles Trophy House in Springfield. Trophies, plaques, medals, gifts, ribbons, and more. You get top quality and great service at Bowles Trophy House, serving Springfield and Southwest Missouri for over 40 years. Call them at 417-869-8720.
And if you need embroidery work done, logos, digitizing, and more, come to Banners and Brainstorms in Bowles Trophy House at 601 South Kimber.
Back at Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton Ice Arena. Steve Kasson, Kurt Busson, Dan Dowell, Scott Lutzky on graphics as we are back for period number two. Guys, a lot of scoring changes to tell you about. The first goal, which we knew was Gallant's goal, or Gallant actually, his fifth, is his goal now, goal number one. Wietop and Frederick will get the assists. Goal number two at 5:02, that is Kelly's goal. Wojcicki will get the only assist, 2-0 Missouri State. The Donovan goal is correct. Murphy and Cummings with the assists, 2-1. And then Brackville, his second at 8:51 for Missouri State. Kelly and add an assist to Brassa. It's 3-1. The 9:41 goal by Raymer, his first of the game, second of the season. Flan will have the assist. It's 4-1. The power play goal by Raymer, his second. Goal of the game and third of the season, Bratton and Brackville with the assists. And then the 19-minute mark goal, McGowan, his second, Gallant, and add an assist to Frederick. Hold on.
Number 89, Caleb Tomlin. 5 minutes for roughing and a game misconduct. Time of that penalty was 14:12 of the first period.
And that is the other change, too. It was roughing. And
that's not insignificant because, as they originally announced that, I believe he said a game disqualification, which would carry a one-game suspension after this game.
So, yeah.
They changed that to just a game misconduct. He should be back in action for their next game.
And actually, I take that back. They didn't. Well, they announced Frederick with the assist, but he is not listed on the score sheet, so we'll leave it as is for now. But we are underway for period number two here. A 6-1 lead as the Ice Bears will skate from the right to the left. And from the left to the right, it will be the Grand Canyon University Lopes. Ice Bears quickly send it out to center ice and all the way down. No icing as it's been waved off. Jack Brackville is there. Gets some help from Garrett Wojcicki, and it's cleared out to center. Wojcicki will send it all the way in, and Griffin will stop it there. Ice Bears battle on the near side, or the far side boards. Now Griffin directs traffic. It comes to the near. Flipped up and not out by Kopinski, but finally it heads over Dent, and we're going to get a penalty.
Yeah, that happened right in front of referee Carrera as Ice Bear player taken down. Pretty obvious call on that one.
Tripping call. It'll be assessed. To Dylan Dent, and the Ice Bears on the power play. They are 2-for-3 on the power play. Shot by Gallant is deflected out after a big save. And Missouri State will go on power play number 4. They already have scored 6, so that means everybody in attendance gets an Andy's frozen custard for $1. Working the power play, Gallant, right side, he shoots, and a save, and it gets deflected up and out of play.
Boy, once again, Ice Bears defensemen have all kinds of time to work that puck down low, time and space, and getting quality shots on net.
That is the 18th shot by Missouri State on Kazabowski. Draws one, Ice Bears have control. Gallant, right side, Frederick, with a left side shot, broke his stick. He's got to go to the bench. And coming on will be Brussa. Threw a bunch of broken sticks, falling down his Flan. He tripped over it. Ice Bears keep it in. Power play for 105. Up high to Brussa. Now cross ice, Gallant drive, and it's up high and a score! May have been deflected in, and if it was, I believe Jacob Wietop will get credit for the goal. And Missouri State has the advantage as Wietop is able to poke it through, and the Ice Bears on the power play. This is their third straight power play goal.
Well, beautiful cross ice pass, and interestingly, that broken stick, which lay on the ice, and the Ice Bears were initially trying to swat it out of the way. The Lopes did him a favor by finishing the job and getting that stick
Ice
out of the way.
Ice Bears power play goal scored by number 74,
much
Jacob
to the
Wheaton.
Bears' advantage is that opened up that ice and
assists
made it
on the play to number 90, Kason Gallant.
For that puck to get across.
And at number 18, Matt McGowan. Time of that power play goal, 1:50 of the second period.
So the Ice Bears, who won yesterday by a count of 15-2, now have a 7-1 advantage, and they're working it again. Bratton and McGowan. Cuts through, does McGowan. Bratton goes in front, right through the crease. Intercepted, though. Preston Larson sends it out, and he'll give it to Messick. Across the Missouri State line, it's kicked out. McGowan couldn't quite handle it. Sent by the Lopes back into the Missouri State zone. They have a 3-on-2 rush, shot sails wide. Now, Nealon with a shot that goes wide. Puck comes in, it's loose. Where is it? It's kicked into the corner. That came off the stick of Schaefer. Held in by Dunick. And then his pass went off of the stick of Petroto, but then cleared by Missouri State. Little trouble at the Lopes line. Ice Bears working some pressure. Now sent all the way down by Carlo Witter. He'll chase his own pass. Witter gets pulled out of the play. A couple of players do a pirouette, and it stays in the zone. Brussa, left side, gets around a check. Brussa drops it off. He's looking to Levi Wright. He shoots, missed. And Brussa is there, and he is able to spin and keep it in with a good stick check. Right up the middle, and the goaltender will see it come right out in front. And Kazabowski will hold on to that. 16:07 to go in the period, and a 7-1 advantage.
More good work on the blue line by the Bears defenseman, showing off that mobility and able to work that puck. Walking the line there, Brussa drops it in the middle and a shot down low. Heads up play there by the Lopes goaltender to finally put a glove on that one and prevent any further play.
Witter sends it back in around the referee. Intercepted by Blake Billings. And as it comes right through, it is going to be a penalty. It's a holding call.
Oh, and linesman takes a tumble there as well to the delight of the crowd here.
Derek Smith will go for Missouri State on the hold. Yeah, that was definitely a hold by Smith coming right through. Whether it was sold or not, it definitely looks like the penalty. And there's unfortunately the official. Apparently, before warm-ups, the official was skating around and he slammed into the boards hard.
Yeah, that one was a little scarier.
Already down one official this weekend.
That's right.
Shot in, tipped, and a save. Schaefer got that. It was tipped right in front from the man standing in front. I believe that was Dunick. Now Billings on the power play for 1:39. This is their second power play. Shot behind the net. Frederick on his knees, he clears. Forechecking is Kelly. Made the goaltender move the puck, and now into the zone, Billings. Forgot the puck. Missouri State able to clear it, and a bounce comes to Louis Shakes. And he'll swipe it into the Missouri, or to the Grand Canyon zone. Missouri State with a line change, though. And 1 minute to go in the power play. Shots 19-8 in favor of Missouri State. Bramer with two goals today sends it in all the way down, no icing. And Shakes will be the only forward in. Puck is loose. Here is Dinnick trying to skate through, broken up. Billings will have it for the Lopes. Billings skates free. Now with 24 seconds to go, left side drive and a save by Griffin, and he's not happy, and Griffin is throwing some punches. Now Kopinski comes in, and this is going to get a little ugly here. Well, Jackie, he got a face mask. His face mask was held, and the officials, I don't believe, saw that one.
Yeah, it's not the first time in this game we've seen some extracurriculars after a goaltender save and a freezing of the puck. A little aggressive on the offensive side. And of course, the defensive team always takes offense to that when you're encroaching in on the goaltender.
And it started with a cross check by Kopinski. So would not be upset if they throw Kopinski in. Yeah, but after that, all the rest of the curriculars should not have happened. We have two for Slash against the Lopes that's in the box right now. And we get a misconduct. Oh, they're going to get 10 minutes to both players. So if Missouri State comes out of this with a two-minute minor on the board against Grand Canyon, I would consider that lucky. And Denick is going to get put on. For 2 minutes.
Yeah, again, a case of catching the retaliation after the initial infraction.
But don't tell the officials, but Wietop was the one with the cross check.
Yeah.
And good thing they're not listening inside the arena on 99.1.
So both teams talking things over at their benches right now.
We know that two players, one from each side, got a 10-minute misconduct. We know that much.
It looks like it's going to be just that additional two-minute minor on the board. So as you said, a break for the Ice Bears. We'll skate 4-on-4 for 21 seconds, and Ice Bears will get Smith back.
And then it will be a short power play, number 5 for Missouri State, in about 21 seconds, barring any further penalties. Let's catch the call.
To Grand Canyon, number 13, Griffin Dunick. 2 minutes for slashing. To number 91, Preston Larson, 10-minute misconduct. And to number 47, Jake Kopinski, 10-minute misconduct. Time of those penalties, 5:46.
All right, someone needs to tell the PA guy to quit playing music while we're listening to things. Meanwhile, a boarding call against Husby. So an additional penalty is on the board. And Missouri State now has power play number 5. They'll have a 2-man advantage in 5 seconds. 7 penalties, 31 minutes for the Lopes. Actually, I take that back. Hold on. 7 penalties, 41 minutes. 8 penalties, 41 minutes.
Penalty on the play to Grand Canyon. Number 6, Braden Husby. 2 minutes for boarding.
Well, that's the call. The Ice Bears on a 2-man advantage for 132. They lead 7-1 here in period 2. Working it is Gallant. Drops it down to Flan. Back up to Gallant. Over to Flan. And it's too hot to handle through the right faceoff circle. Behind the net, McGowan. He'll try to work it out in front. It does. It comes through the skates of Wietop, and he's not able to hold on to it. Gallant gets dumped. Play continues. Ice Bears still working the puck. Near side, out in front. Wietop up high, and he missed. Power play, 2-man advantage for 54. Shot comes in by Frederick, and it deflects and a save by Kalibowski.
Heads up play there by Frederick, getting that puck on goal. puts it on the ice, looking for that deflection down low. But the Lopes goaltender able to pick it up, make the save. 52 seconds to go in the first penalty to Grand Canyon. And they'll get a man back.
Next stoppage in play, Dan Dowell, unless you know what happened in the UNLV-Utah game, we'll have you mention to us here in a moment. Meanwhile, it's the Ice Bears with possession. 36 seconds remaining in the two-man advantage. Malthiner, he'll have it up high. Crisscross with Brussa. He shoots and he missed an open net up high to the right. Ice Bears now work it for 22 more seconds on the two-man advantage. Malthiner calls for it. Off the left side, it goes off of the stick of Brackbill. Now to Brussa. Left side again. Working it through, it's deflected by a Lope. Power play with 8 seconds in the two-man advantage. Missouri State now with 4 seconds. This will be power play number 6. Shot comes in and a save just as time expires. That one came from Malthiner. And 16 seconds remaining in the second part of the power play, number 6 for Missouri State. Dan, do you know that score?
Yes. UNLV ended up coming back to win in overtime 4-3 over the Skating Utes of Utah.
So for ACHA purposes, that's a tie, I believe.
In overtime even?
Rank as a save here as Shakes got the shot. Rankings-wise, any tied game is considered, after regulation, is considered a tie for rankings. Records-wise, UNLV gets the win.
I thought it was just a shootout that was considered the tie, but you could be right.
Well, let's have Chris Perry, if he's watching, text us and let us know. But that's what I thought, at least for rankings. 12 seconds remaining of the power play. Ice Bears will work it behind the net. Shakes looking for a cross-ice pass. He connects with Raymer. He shoots in and a save by Kazabowski.
You know, tricky save there, almost snuck through, but Kazabowski able to smother it. 3 seconds remaining on the Lopes penalty.
Off the draw, the Ice Bears have it again. Power play is over. Wright with a shot in, save, rebound, loose, and Shakes couldn't get it to go through. Now Shakes again. Louis up high. Wright, he shoots, deflects it through a bouncing puck held onto by Kazabowski. Shots are 24-9. We came into the period at 17-8.
Yeah, not a lot of action down in front of us here in the Ice Bear zone. It's been all looking to our left as the Ice Bears continue to put pressure on.
Ice Bears will gain possession after the draw. Sent behind the net. Somehow it gets over to Brackbill. Off of a Lope and out to center ice and all the way down for Raymer. Billings to Chase for Grand Canyon. They steal the puck briefly. Wojcicki. He'll lead a 3-on-4 into the zone. Drop back to Brackbill. He shoots and he just missed wide. Frederick on the ice. Sent over to Kelly. Getting dumped in front is Brackbill. And he trips a man. We're going to get a penalty. It's going to go against Brackbill. And once Missouri State touches up, they do now. And Brackbill will go for tripping.
Well, as that penalty expired to Grand Canyon, I was hoping for some penalty-free 5-on-5 action for a while for a change, but not the case, as this time it'll be the Ice Bears going to the box.
Third power play, I believe, for the Lopes, based on the fact that we had all of those consecutive penalties for each side. I'm a little surprised, unless my notes are wrong, which I wouldn't put it past me at all. Nealon in to take the draw from Shakes of Missouri State. Shakes wins it to Frederick, stolen by Billings. Power play now with a 7-1 lead for Missouri State for the visiting Lopes. Left side, drive in, saved by Griffin, or to use the words of Doc Emmerich, waffle boarded away. Here's Malthiner. Behind the net to Nealon. Over to Billings, he shoots and a save! Had an open net, and sliding back out in front was Griffin to close it off, and it's cleared all the way down.
Griffin hasn't had a lot of action in this one, but when he's been called upon, he's been huge, making some big saves.
Puck is taken away. McGowan will chase into the Lopes zone. 1:10 to go. Ice Bears with a short change. Puck sent all the way down. This should be an ice. Nope, they're going to wave it off. No icing. Puck is cleared. This one is not because Missouri State is shorthanded. Small change for the Lopes. Grand Canyon did not play last season. First time in a while they've been on the ice, and they start off with a five-game road trip. Here coming in, out in front, Billings will score. Moore sets up Billings. And Blake Billings will get his first goal with Grand Canyon this season. That's why he was happy about that. 7-2.
Yeah, that was just a great hustle play all the way by the Lopes. Down the left wing, sends it in front. Man crashing the net on the right wing. Able to bury it home. Nothing Griffin could have done about that one.
10:27 will be the time of the goal for Grand Canyon to get goal number two on their just 12th shot. And I don't know if they asked who scored the goal or what, but it should be Billings from Moore. Meanwhile, Missouri State will clear the puck. Bramer in his own zone. Coming up at the second period intermission, it'll be a talk with Caden Hintz. Shot comes in off of the back of
Reddick. Grand Canyon goal scored by number 10, Blake Billings. Assisted by number 88, Nate Moore. Time of the goal, 10:27 of the second period. 10 assisted by 8.
So a 7-2 lead now. And it's centered right out in front. Husby had it deflected right through the crease. Riddick is there. Gallant for Missouri State, and he does clear it. Kaysen all the way down. Kaysen Gallant came in at one of the leaders with 4 goals and 4 assists, but today Gallant gets his 5th, and he also has 2 assists to boot.
Big weekend for him. He's been all over the place.
At center. Puck sent all the way down. McNeil now on the ice. I'll have to double check. Yeah, that is 59. Jake McNeil, his 2nd game. Now a shot comes in that Kazabowski holds on to with 8 minutes left in period number 2 and a 7-2 lead for Missouri State.
I think that 2nd goal by the Lopes definitely gave them some life as they continue to put pressure on the Ice Bears end. First time in this game we've seen that in a while. It's been mostly Ice Bears all the way, but a little sustained pressure there. So a push from the Lopes, and Ice Bears will have to answer.
Shot comes in. It's loose right through the crease, and not able to put it home was McGowan. After Frederick's right side shot. Now again, Frederick will lift it up. Keeps it into the right side. Trying to poke it away was Dunnick. But here is a shot by Ross that comes through. And Missouri State with more pressure. They must have heard you. McGowan. Down in low. Gets it to Bratton. Over to Malthiner left side. Ice Bears working this like it's a power play, but it's not. It's 5-on-5. Oh, puck is taken away now. Ross tries to race, but here comes Puttich in front. He shoots, and a save. Moore will chase it for the Lopes. Moore with a nice toe drag, and he couldn't get it through the crease. Puck cleared out to center, and Missouri State with a line change. Goaltender was calling since Missouri State was changing for the puck to get sent up, and Donovan couldn't get it in time. Now it's Wojcicki for Missouri State. Puck cleared, and Brassa will have it. We should get down to the point where the 10-minute misconducts are over. I know Smith and Kopinski. So hopefully we'll get a couple of those guys back. Maltener. Over to Wojcicki. Left side. Wojcicki will send it through. Now a shot by Kelly is blocked. Brassa keeps it in. Nice move. Oh, and it went off of the stick of Kelly. Another broken stick, and a couple of players fall down in front. Finally, it's flipped out to center. Kelly was set up with a perfect pass, and he tried to shovel it, and he missed it. We're going to get an icing call here. 5:51 to go in the period, and a 7-2 lead for Missouri State.
Steve, I want to give a shout-out to the D3 Ice Bears. They had a good weekend heading up north for three games. Started out Thursday night with a big win over Illinois State, and then they went into Milwaukee and split with UM Milwaukee, losing the first one in a tough one, and then ending the weekend with a big victory today. So congrats on the boys for their 2-1 weekend.
And Missouri State, I believe, going 2-1 means, if I can do my math, that they're 5-3 on the season, I believe. Good start for Division III. Now we get a whistle for a stoppage. Everyone congratulating each other, saying, are we going to civil afterwards?
Yeah.
And no, Stewart says, nah, we're going home. So a full line change for everybody. Seven-two Missouri State. Steve Kasson, Dan Dell, Kurt Busson, and Scott Lutzke on graphics for us here tonight. Puck sent away and cleared all the way down, but it's not going to be an icing because racing is Bratton. He steals the puck. Bratton keeps it in play. Bratton looking for a wraparound, and he gets it, but a save by Kazabowski.
Nice hustle there by Bratton as he's first man in all alone. Unfortunately, couldn't catch up to it before the goaltender did, but stuck with it. Able to work it around the behind the net, works himself in front, free for a shot. And all around good hustle play there by him.
So Jared Bratton now playing in a line with Louis Shakes and Carlo Witter. So things a little changed up here by head coach Jeremy Law. Puck at center, good kick to keep it in play by Raymer. Flip back in, Wright is there, 4:57 to go. Now Raymer, Potich with a check. It's out to center. Sent all the way down, but no icing as it's on goal, and it will be held on to by the goaltender. Kind of a quick whistle there as Shakes raced home.
That was a quick whistle. I thought maybe we were going to get something behind the play there, but I think it was just a quick whistle on the other end.
29-15 are the shots in favor of Missouri State. Yesterday's game ended 49-34.
Overall, the pace has kind of slowed a little bit here as we near the 16-minute mark of the second period, late in this period.
Ice Bears take it out. Backhander by Gallant. Stopped in front. Maltener, and as he's trying to keep it in, he tripped Cummings, but play continues.
Caught a break on that one.
Wietop into the corner. Nice elbow check on Nealon. Ice Bears get a shot from the right side, and it's held on to by Kazabowski.
Got a packed house here today as well, which is good to see. This new 5 p.m. format on Saturdays, not really sure how that was going to work out, but look in the crowd, see lots of families and a full grandstand of Ice Bear fans. So they got the memo, no problem there, and working out great so far.
Shot comes in, and the Ice Bears keep it. A wraparound out in front, and a save as Flan got the shot from behind the net, and another good save there by Kazabowski. Speaking of a big crowd, next week Missouri State is hoping that we get a big crowd, because coming in will be Central Oklahoma, and the Ice Bears.
Those games are always entertaining.
Yeah, I don't know if you remember the mention in the open, if you were here, but Missouri State has not lost a home WCHL league game since November of 2019.
Got to keep that going.
Knock on the wood. This, of course, is a WCHL game. Buck sent in, a delayed offside, and the Ice Bears clear the zone. It's out to center. Flan will backhand it in. Over to Cummings. Jacob Cummings, three goals. I'll make that one goal and three assists. He's out of Anchorage, Alaska. Now Flan, cross ice pass, meets Gallant. Left side, Gallant, nice move. Gallant tried to center it through. Up the middle, nobody there, and Brussa is able to keep it in. Slow enough, so he could. Now the Lopes. Can't clear it. Gallant still with it, trying to work the puck. It's out to center. Back down. Brussa needs to hurry. Brussa loses it. Here comes Stewart in front. He shoots. He scores! Colin Stewart makes it 7-3. And you got to kind of fault Noah Brussa there. He had possession of the puck, and he thought he would try to hit him.
Yeah, he went for the big hit there and just kind of stopped him in his tracks, unfortunately.
And Stewart just went right around him.
When it works, it's a great play, and the crowd loves it. But if you misfire like that, unfortunately, you're flat-footed, and Stewart knew what to do on that one.
He gets his first goal of the season, and it is 7-3.
Goal scored by number 90, Colin Stewart. Time of the goal, 17:02. Number 90 unassisted.
So a 7-3 game now. Here is Kopinski with a partially fanned on shot. It's cleared out to center. But it's a good thing that Missouri State has goals to give. You don't want to see that. But they do have goals to give right now.
Right, you don't want to give them any daylight. And after they scored their second goal, you could really see how it just kind of lifted them, and they were able to carry that momentum for a good couple minutes after that. We'll see how the Ice Bears respond here, as I'm sure we're going to get this push continued by the Lopes.
2:23 remains in the period. Puck flipped out to center. And Wojcicki, cross ice pass. Cannot connect with Hintz. Shot in, and it's deflected up and out of play by the goaltender Kazabowski. Faceoff will stay in the zone. Second period intermission guest will be the guy that just got the shot, Caden Hintz. So what is it? I have
almost hit his cue there, huh?
I was going to say, do I have to interview him first before he scores? Is that the way it works? Buck is flipped out to center and all the way down off the draw back into the Missouri State zone for an icing call.
Best impression of family dentistry with Dr. Aaron Daniger is happy to support Ice Bears.
Just a reminder that Dr. Aaron Daniger at Best Impressions Family Dentistry is happy to support the Ice Bears and Ice Bears hockey. With services catered to every generation, Best Impressions can take care of your family dental needs. Visit them at bestimpressionsdental.com. Right off the draw again. Another save. So more pressure again by Missouri State. And off the draw again, it'll be Kopinski. Back out to center, and Kopinski is going to get called for tripping. Stuck his stick out, and I guess they're going to call it a slash.
Yeah, it did look like more of a trip, I thought, when I saw the initial play. But nevertheless, another power play opportunity here for Grand Canyon. Key moment in this game is, again, you don't want to let them sneak back into it late in this second period. 1:42 to go in the period.
Seven penalties, 30 minutes for Missouri State. And I think it's because you heard it. So Kopinski gets out of the box, and he's right back in. Power play as a shot comes in, just missed wide. Now out in front, Demick with a save, and Griffin is just not happy.
He does not like folks skating through the crease there. Cooler heads prevail this time, though. No further pushing and shoving after the whistle. And we'll get a face-off to Griffin's left here.
.144 to go off the draw. Missouri State does clear it. Just barely makes it over the stick of Schaefer. Oh, stolen by Derek Smith. He blasts, he shoots, and a save. Kazabowski with a huge save there as Missouri State
Just right to the tape of Smith, he's able to just walk in from the blue line, winds up with a shot and a great save to bail his teammate out from the Lopes goaltender there on that giveaway in their zone.
So now there's 1 minute remains.
For the Lopes player down at center ice in a collision and some pain. Get a stoppage for that. Just under a minute to go here in the second period as the trainer's on the ice. He's slowly getting to his feet. We'll wait and see if there's a call on this. Referees are talking things over.
Not sure what we'll see on this. .73 score for Missouri State. Gallant, Kelly, Brackbill, Raymer with two, McGowan, Wheatop, and then for Grand Canyon, it's Donovan, Billings, and Stewart, and all three of those scorers got their first goal of the year for Grand Canyon.
It's been a while since the Ice Bears have dented the net. They've been stuck on seven here for a while after putting 15 on the board last night. Currently shorthanded. We'll see if there's an additional call here.
So Brussa apparently is going to go to the penalty box, and he is assessed 5 minutes. Interesting. I don't know what took place.
I didn't see it either. I saw the man on the ice at the center ice line. And we'll have to wait and see if it's a game misconduct or a disqualification.
Number 20, Noah Brussa. 5 minute major for slashing. Time of the penalty, 19:02 of the second period. 5 minute major slashing.
Unfortunately, it's
interesting.
Only the 5 minute major. It could have been worse. But still not good for the Ice Bears as they're faced with a two-man deficit now.
Lopes on power play number five. Petroto up high, swung down in low by Potich. Over to Donovan, back to Petroto. Potich blast in, blocked by Shakes, and he clears up into the bench where it's caught by backup goaltender. for the Ice Bears and Ross Jones.
Great job there by Shakes to block that puck up high.
Wait, I think that was Stevens. Oh, that was Bailey Stevens that got that. Do it again. Shakes to win the draw. Smith is there for Missouri State. Derek battles for it. Good possession there. But it's dug out and Donovan will have it. Cross ice. Back to Petroto. Working it down to Potich. Over to Petroto. He shoots. Deflected away by a diving Smith. Petroto works it up high. Gets it to Potich. He shoots. It's blocked in front by Shakes. Glove down by Smith. Piece pushed off the puck. Moore with it. In front of Potich. Broken up by Shakes. And the period comes to an end.
Oh, my goodness. What a shift by Louis Shakes. Two block shots and then sprawling on his belly prevents that last second pass from getting through and bails the Ice Bears out late in that period and preserved the 7-3 lead going into the third period.
For Missouri State, Matt Griffin faces 8 shots in the period and 16 shots. Let me do my math here. It is not 16 shots. It is 15 shots for two period total of 33 that Kazabowski faced. Dan, we'll leave it to you right now for assessment of that period. What did you think through the eye of the camera?
I think if you're Missouri State, I kind of felt like at least towards the middle spots of that period, they were kind of not necessarily resting on their laurels per se. We kind of saw that with the Bressa turnover in the defensive zone that led to a goal. But outside of that, I think Missouri State's done well on the forecheck, and I think Kurt hit the nail on the head again with that penalty kill in the later stages of that second period. A great job by the duo of Chase and Smith blocking shots and trying to clear the puck out of the zone. And if you're Missouri State, you'd have to figure that would bring some momentum going into the third period.
Can you argue that Missouri State has played a 60-minute game? Or do you put an asterisk on this?
That's a good question. I think they've played well, but like most games, you're just going to have a few hiccups here and there. And if you're Missouri State, or if you're Grand Canyon, they've been able to capitalize on the minor mistakes that Missouri State has done. But if you're Missouri State going into this third period, just keep the pressure up and up the pressure a little bit more, because as you guys had mentioned, there wasn't a whole lot of offense from Missouri State's end towards the end of that period, but they were also in the box for the majority of that as well.
When we come back in the third period, 17 seconds will still be left in the penalty to Jake Kopinski, and 4:01 left in the major to Noah Bressa. And that major means that Grand Canyon can score at will. So they'll have a 2-man advantage to start the period, and a lot of opportunity there. That's got to help a team that's trailing by 4, knowing you're going to get a man advantage for at least, barring any further penalties, 4 minutes into that third period.
Yeah, and Grand Canyon's done an excellent job in that second period of being able to place their shots and pick their shots, as opposed to the first period where it seemed like the majority of the play was in their own end.
Missouri State is 3-for-6 on the power play. That's helped them extend this lead. Raymer, McGowan, and Wietop with power play goals. The only power play goal in the second period was at 1:50. That was Wietop's goal. The other two came late in the first at 19, 17, and 19 minutes. Raymer and McGowan respectively. For the Lopes, they are 0-for-5. They're working on power play number 6. And we'll see what happens when we return for period number 3. We'll take a break, and when we come back, talk to Caden Hintz of Missouri State. We'll do that in just a moment. After 40 minutes of play, Missouri State hanging on to a 7-3 lead. We'll be back.
This is Barrel Bob, MoDOT's Work Zone spokesbarrel. You'll be seeing more of me as the weather warms up. Crews will be working on our roads. That means lanes will be closed for construction and maintenance work on our highways. As you approach a work zone, please don't drive distracted. You need to pay attention. I want you and my friends working on the roads to all get home safely. Remember, buckle up and put down your phone. A message from the Missouri Department of Transportation.
Back at Jordan Valley Ice Park, Steve Gasson now with Caden Hintz of Missouri State, the senior out of Regina, Saskatchewan, Canada. And Caden, you've had a chance to get your feet wet here with Missouri State. What's it like?
It's been fun so far. I transferred from a small school, so it's everything I was looking for. A good school, the boys are good, and the staff have been really amazing with us.
What's it been like? Well, I know what it's been like, but what made you decide to come here to Missouri State?
I had a couple options. I was supposed to finish a year early at my old school, but COVID hit, and then I kind of wanted to play more hockey. So I heard a lot of good things about Missouri State, and I chose them over a couple of good schools, but they're an even better school. So I was really happy with my decision.
You didn't have anybody that played here that made your decision?
I had a couple of friends who played with guys on the team, and they kind of influenced, and the weather also. I was living somewhere cold, so.
Well, that's the thing. Regina's probably, I don't know, 24-hour snow for 12 months out of the year?
Oh, yeah. About 6 months out of the year, it's snowing, and then 2 to 3 other months are cold. Get some minus 50 in there.
Do you ever get any sunshine? I mean, is there such thing as the beach?
I don't think it looks like it got much sunshine.
No, it does not. That's funny.
2 months of that.
But it's still, because hockey is the sport there, you still have the advantage. You get to go out. You get to skate outdoors half the time. Yeah. I mean, some things that people here have never experienced, you did on a daily basis.
Oh, yeah. It's in our bloodline. Like, there's 8 outdoor rinks by my house alone. So
that's crazy.
Yeah, just in our neighborhood alone. So it's fun. Winter's my favorite time of year, honestly. I love going to the rink, tobogganing, stuff like that. So
I mean, do you know how many people, if this place is closed down, Jordan Valley Ice Park, they freak out?
Yeah.
And you've got 8 that you can go to at any one time?
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. And then there's a bunch of indoor rinks too. So you got a lot of options. Hockey is everywhere in Saskatchewan.
So tell me this. Are the rinks open 24/7?
No, usually 11 o'clock they probably close down. 6 a.m. they open probably for practices, stuff like that.
If you knew the switch, could you kick on those lights at an outdoor rink and just get out there and play at 2 in the morning?
Yeah, sometimes we'll play in the dark. Me and my buddies, when I go home for Christmas every year from hockey, we'll play till like 3 in the morning in the dark even. Or find like some cars to put around the rink and turn the lights on.
That's crazy. Yeah. So there's moon? Actually, the moon can light that up a little bit?
Yeah, it can. And get some bright lights going there on the vehicles.
That would be a lot of fun.
It is. It's cold, but it's fun.
That's the one thing. After a while, you're pretty much down to what you're wearing now, just sweats and a shirt, right?
Yeah. When you're moving, you want to wear less. If you wear too much winter clothing, you start sweating, then you get cold.
Caden Hintz is joining us of Missouri State out of Regina, Saskatchewan, Canada. A couple of Canadians on the team. They're from different areas. Do you guys kind of discuss, hey, I'm from a better area than you?
Yeah, that's a pretty common trait. Gets ugly sometimes, but the boys from Vancouver got a lot of bragging rights. It's a pretty nice city they're from, but I try and represent Saskatchewan as best I can.
Hey, but you've got the snow.
Exactly. We got the outdoor rinks. They don't got any other.
Absolutely. I mean, they have nice trees and all, but
some mountains.
But you have that too, and you have snow and more snow and things like
more
that.
More snow.
Do you remember the first time you got on skates?
I was like 2 years old, so it was a while ago, but my father would take me. I remember to a rink right by our house and take me skating, whether if it was pushing a chair or something like that. We would go a couple times a week during the winter.
Rumor has it that Canadians are able to skate better because their parents knew how to skate, and they actually know how to train their kids better. It's just a rumor. I'm just passing on this rumor. I don't know. Can Canadians skate better than Americans?
I'm going to say yes, but I'm going to give the Americans... You guys play different, and I noticed that skating's a big part of the game. Actually, it's pretty cool playing down here. It's a different style. So the Americans skate a lot more, whereas I find Canada's more physical.
Do you think it's maybe because Canadians have grown up maybe skating, and so there's not that much emphasis on having to skate because you already know how to skate?
Yeah, like I said, a lot of us start at ages 2 or 3. I find a lot of my buddies have started at that age, so we're doing it for a while, and yeah, practice makes perfect, hopefully, so.
Caden Hintz of Missouri State's joining us. You are a senior.
Yeah.
But the way the ACHA works, you probably could play another year.
Yeah, so last year, I took last year off, and I decided to transfer here, so I got this year, and if I want to play next year, I can play as well. Which is a pretty good option. So I got a couple more years of school, and hopefully we can make something happen here.
Now, your parents don't care that you're going an extra year, or do they even know yet?
I'm trying to pay for school myself. So
okay, so it's up to you whether you go or not.
Obviously they support me where I need it. So they've been terrific with that. But they're just happy. They think this experience is really cool. So
all right, who buys your sticks?
I bought them this year.
Okay.
But I go a little old school, so with the Sherwoods.
A lot of people do, you know? A lot of people have gone to that old school.
Yeah.
I don't know. You would think that the aluminum sticks would stay longer, but apparently they don't. Apparently people like the wood ones.
The wood ones, yeah. I stand in front of the net a lot, so I need them.
There you go. Caden Hintz is our guest. Brothers and sisters?
I got two sisters.
Do they play at all?
No, they never played both basketball.
Okay, but they do play sports.
Yeah, and my older sister was in the Canada Games for rowing as well. So
that's awesome.
Yeah, it was a pretty cool experience. She got to go to Montreal. So
did you get to go check them out too?
I had hockey tryouts, so I couldn't go. My whole family went except me, so left me alone while everyone was enjoying Montreal. So
you know, it just figures. And yeah. First of all, if you would have said, oh, yeah, I went and missed hockey tryouts, I would have said, are you crazy?
Yeah.
But, yeah, hockey tryouts is a very good excuse for not going, obviously.
Yeah.
Did your parents and her come see a lot of your games?
Yeah, my family's been really supportive my whole life. And I've played all over, so I've always been away from home. So they catch every game they can. They've been really good.
Do you remember your first goal ever?
I can't say I did. I remember my first hat trick.
Okay, let's talk. Let's hear about that.
Just a couple backdoor plays, good teammates, just finding openings. When I was little, I had better hands, let's say that.
Better hands than you do now? Do you think so?
No.
So the goose eggs are still there. I know you're trying to shake that off.
Yeah.
Do you have an idea, like, what your celly's going to be when you score?
Oh, I can get pretty excited sometimes, but it's been a couple years since I've actually played hockey, so I'll try and act like I've scored a goal before, but if I get a couple, who knows?
Well, I'll be sure to try to call your first goal.
Okay.
A couple of guys yesterday missed their first goal call because the scoring was coming unbelievably fast, so hopefully I'll try to do you justice in that respect.
Hey. Thank you very much.
Caden Hintz is joining us. What is some of your... Do you have any rituals? You know, is there something that you do before a game?
Obviously, music's a big one. Not tying my right skate before my left skate is my superstition.
Okay, so it's left, then right?
Yeah.
And that's kind of what it is. I'm a goalie, and that's kind of what it is for me.
Yeah.
I got to make sure I got this right. Yeah, I think I do the left leg pad, get all that ready to go first, and then I go with the right.
Yeah, it has to be that way, or I have to start over again, so.
Ooh. And for me, if I mess up, I guess I just think about it too much. As for a goalie, you can't start all over.
No. No, it's a little tougher that way.
But I will say the thing that I don't understand about forwards, defensemen, just guys that don't play goaltender, it could be 10, 15 minutes before game time. You don't have a stitch of any of your gear on.
No.
I look up, and you're ready to go, and I still have one leg pad to go.
Yeah.
How do you guys do that?
just repetition. I think everyone's shown up to the rink really late. I know Beer League has got me practice for that, showing up 5 minutes before the game and trying to get on the ice as quick as you can. So
that's crazy. Yeah. I mean, I've shown up 10 minutes before game time before, and I will admit, and it was difficult, but that was the fastest I ever got dressed.
Yeah.
I don't think I played well because I couldn't even remember what I tied. Caden Hintz is joining us of Missouri State. Okay, a couple of quick things. Who has the best dress? Who dresses the best on Missouri State?
Ooh, going off today, I want to shout out my roommate Carlo Witter. He had the cowboy hat going on, so today it was. I'll give it to Carlo.
Okay, yeah. For today we'll do that.
Yeah.
Who has had the funniest chirp line on the bench?
I think Jake Kopinski, my other roommate, had some good ones yesterday, but
nothing you can say.
No, I'll keep it to him if he wants to reveal that.
Okay, sounds good. Who on the team has a stick that you really wish you had right now?
Ooh, maybe Gallant, who you just interviewed. He scored a nice goal yesterday, so I might have to use his.
Oh, well, every time I interview people, they score, so we'll see what happens. Hey. But who's your favorite NHL team?
Calgary Flames. The 04 Cup run really did it for me. So.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, their new coach, who I absolutely love because he used to coach for L.A., Mr. Sutter, hopefully they'll do something with him this year.
Yeah, they got a good roster. They lost Giordano, though. I was quite upset about that. So.
But I will admit, Calgary's kind of got a soft heart spot in my heart, that's for sure.
Why is that?
Because Lanny McDonald.
Oh, I met Lanny McDonald. Yeah, he's a good guy.
Yeah, he's a blast. And you know, some of the players that have gone and come through, I used to work for L.A., the Kings, and so I knew of some of the players. And so Calgary has a soft spot in my heart.
That's awesome. Lanny McDonald's got the best mustache. I'm trying to repeat it.
Yes, he does. How are you really?
I can't grow it like his. I can't even compare it.
Well, it looks like you just started, basically.
Yeah.
Caden, thanks so much. Caden, thanks so much for doing this. Caden Hintz is joining us. And as I said, I always wish players at the end of interviews more goals. Hopefully you'll get that for the rest of the season. And again, thanks for doing this.
Thank you very much for having me.
All right, we'll take a break. Be back. More hockey is coming up.
We all love the fajitas. Their margaritas get the crown. Don't forget the quesadillas. It's the best Mexican food in town.
Now your favorite Mexican restaurant is open on Sunday. Yes, Maria's Downtown is open on Sunday. So bring your family and friends and enjoy Mexico with us 7 days a week.
Hold on to your salsa and your chips.
Maria's on South Avenue in downtown Springfield.
Back at Jordan Valley Ice Park, Stan Melton Ice Arena. Steve Casson, Dan Dell, Kurt Bussin, Scott Lutzky on graphics. Thanks for tuning in. The Ice Bears with a 7-3 lead as we're about to head into the second period. And again, they will be shorthanded two men. 17 seconds on the penalty to Jake Kopinski. And 4:01 remains in the penalty to Noah Brusa. And guys, I don't know if Missouri State just needs to ignore period number two, put the pedal to the metal, and say the rest will be history, or if Grand Canyon may take advantage of some of the miscues Missouri State has had.
Well, and if we're looking at the end of that second period, Steve, I think Missouri State did a great job on the penalty kill with the 5-on-3 that still, as you said, is 17 seconds remaining on it. See if they can get some momentum off of that and kind of get a boost for the offensive kind of side of things. The offense kind of sputtered out a little bit in the second half of that period. They had some grade A chances. It just wasn't a lot of them.
This weekend is Missouri State Hockey's Parent Weekend. On behalf of all the players, coaches, staff members, and volunteers,
we would like to say a very special thank you. College is an exciting time in these young men and women's lives. It can be very challenging and in different ways, and your love and support are graciously appreciated. Thank you for your dedication and support. All of our Ice Bears parents, please be recognized, stand up, and have a round of applause.
Of course, it is Parents Weekend, too. So a big round of applause for all the parents that were here. But, Dan, if you're the coach right now, what are you telling Missouri State for period number three?
If I'm Coach Law, I would probably tell the boys just to ride out this penalty kill, keep as minimal damage as you can, and then kind of up the pressure, get the pedal back on the metal a little bit, see if they can notch in a couple more goals. Because I think if you're Grand Canyon, you kind of have a little bit of hope given the circumstances and the amount of players that are going to be on the ice to start this third. But at any rate, it is still 7-3, so Missouri State's still sitting comfortably, but maybe not necessarily as comfortable as the 7-1 lead.
Well, Missouri State will not be that comfortable when Central Oklahoma, comes into town next weekend. And if they're trying to scare Central Oklahoma with Missouri State's big scoring here this weekend, we'll wait to see if that does anything. But can you imagine, Kurt, going back to several years ago when Missouri State swept Central Oklahoma at home? It was the first time ever they had swept Central Oklahoma. Now it seems like Missouri State can't lose to that hockey club.
It is. Well, for whatever reason, we've always had their number. Like I said, even when they're, you know, vying for national championships, which they seem to be often, Ice Bears always give them a solid run for their money. And oftentimes able to get over the hump against them and put a W up. And that weekend you're talking about was awesome. We swept them in those two games.
Meanwhile, the first part of the two-man advantage has expired. Now there's 3:39 left in the major as Missouri State starts this period defending to the left. And it's still in the Missouri State zone. Power play for 3:27. Works up high to Billings. He swipes it over to the right side. Billings again will get it up high. Looking down in low, a shot that's in and held on to by Griffin.
Again, shots getting through, but fortunately Griffin able to pick them up all the way and making it look rather routine with that save as he's able to pick it up.
Face off the right of Griffin and off the draw. It'll be sent by the Ice Bears, but unfortunately it's stolen. A drive in off the stick of Potich is sent into the corner. 3:04 to go in the power play. It's cleared all the way down, and Petroto will have it. Anthony Petroto, one goal and two assists for the sophomore out of Phoenix, Arizona. Up to Moore. Right side to Potich. Ice Bears Kelly is there. He can't break it up. 2:47 remains. Missouri State leads 7-3. Dug out behind the Missouri State net. Trying to work with it is Moore. He wants Moore.
Nice.
He'll send it right down in. Looking to the far side. I saw you look at me like, how did you do that?
Doesn't miss a trick over there, Mr. Casson.
Moore sends it to the corner. Still a scrum at the half boards. Spun around and shot to the right side. Comes right through again on a return pass. 2:06 to go in the five-minute major. Potich keeps it in. Cross-ice pass, a blast in front off the stick of Petroto is steered aside by Griffin. Here's Donovan looking in front with a drive that misses. 1:47 to go. Potich keeps it in. Donovan to help out. Still looking for the puck. And now Donovan carries it through. He still has it. He's down on, as he slides right through, the goaltender is able to keep it from going in. Schaefer swings it over to the right side. Now the left side and a drive and a save. Billings got that. Actually, no, I think it was Cummings that got that, 33. And Griffin with a save. It's still 7-3. Now on the ice is Nealon. Shot comes in, save Griffin, rebound to the corner. On his knees is an Ice Bear trying to clear it in the corner. Can he do it? It's out to center ice. That was Brackville, and it's all the way down into the lopes, into the ice. Cummings around his own net. Shakes, trips him up, and we're going to get a penalty.
Here we go again. Another two-man advantage coming up.
And Shakes will go to the box.
Well, you hear it all the time, Steve, the old adage that your number one penalty killer has to be your goaltender. And we saw that on display in that last flourish as Griffin coming up huge on several good opportunities there from the lopes. And they'll have to be strong once again as Ice Bears find themselves down two men once again in this game.
Off the draw to be won by Grand Valley. Here's Schaefer. With Shake's penalty, that's 37 minutes in penalties on 9 penalties. Here's a drive in. Oh, what a save! It came off the stick of Billings, and sliding over was Griffin to get a glove on it. It's still 7-3. Here it comes to Cummings. Blocked out in front. It's loose, and it goes to the far side. Nobody there. Billings with it again. He'll try to work it. Billings up high. Gives it, or make that to Cummings from Billings. Now a shot in. And now another power play. This is number 8. Here is Cummings with a drive, and the power play is over. And out of the box is Brussa. He'll come in all alone. He shoots, and he missed just wide. Cummings will pick it up. 1:02 to go. I believe this is power play number 9. Getting dumped down in front was Gallant. Or was that Witter, number 91? It was Witter, I believe. Puck kicked out to center. Here come the Ice Bears, and tripping was Witter. But he's able to bring it in across the line. Billings with a check. Witter shoots and a save. McGowan is there, can't pick it up. They are trying to break Husby, but instead it'll be a 2-on-2 into the zone. 24 seconds remaining in the power play. Still 7-3. That's where we started period number 3. Puck out to center and sent all the way down. And no icing. Line change for both teams. Petroto with Ross on his tail. Donovan is there. Lead to Petroto. Flip down. Griffin to steer into the corner. Enough for Ross to clear. Off the skate of Shakes. And now sent back to the Missouri State end. Couple of players, Shakes, and I believe Moore collide, and we're going to get a hand pass, I believe.
Back to even strength for the Ice Bears, so they're able to kill off another one. And let's cross our fingers that we can skate 5-on-5 here for a while and stay out of the penalty box.
9 penalties, 37 minutes for Missouri State. 8 penalties, 41 minutes for Grand Canyon. Derek Smith, after the win, sends it through. Gabowski will send it to the near side boards. Bratton to intercept, helped down low by McGowan. Intercepted by Schaefer of the Lopes. Now Schaefer to move it. Across the line in the Missouri State zone. Smith with a good flip out all the way down, and not enough to cause an icing. Oh, yes, it is. So Missouri State cannot change. Faceoff will come back into the Ice Bears, into the ice. Our next game coming up. Our next game coming up. Can't do it. 13:56 to go in the period. We'll catch that one of these days. Meanwhile, puck is one sent to the far side. Samuel Wiedenbaum on the ice for the first time. To the corner. Off the stick of Preston Larson. Behind the net. Try to work it to Misek. No power play. Puck centered up the middle, and it is cleared. Here comes Bratton with a 3-on-2, although they break that apart because Missouri State wants the line change. Frederick to forecheck. Now it's right. Actually, that was right. 13, not 3. Raymer sends it to the far side. Held in, though, by the Lopes' Wiedenbaum. As he sent it back for his defense, they help him out. Now it'll go to Moore. Misek there. Fans yelling, "Let's go Bears." They haven't had a goal since period number 2. Flan to Kopinski. Raymer right side. Raymer shoots and it gets deflected. And the official says played with a high stick. .12:38 to go. Here in the third period, and faceoff will come outside the zone because it was played with a high stick.
Finally, some offensive pressure again from the Bears. Now that they're out of the box, back to even strength, and hopefully can mount some offense here, as Dan had mentioned earlier, kind of chasing it from the deficit side. And
Flan steals, sorry, Kurt, to Kopinski. And Kopinski loses his stick. He's going to the bench. Donovan clears it out. Kopinski has to play D now, even though he has no stick, and the puck is deflected into the corner. 12:11 to go. Good play by Kopinski. He could have went to the bench and let the player skate in through, but he stayed in the play. Doesn't have a stick, but he's a body out there. Shot to the corner. Gallant. Chased in and sent all the way around. Cummings not able to hold on to it for GCU. To the point, and it stays along the line sent by Nealon. Near side. Nealon still holds it in. Calling for it is Petroto. An Ice Bear gets dumped on the left circle. He's down, shot in, just missing wide, and having to get. Well, he's going to stay in the play as Raymer. He's hurting, though.
Yeah, he's favoring that leg badly.
And Raymer's getting off the ice. Here's a break as Gallant sends it from the blue line on. He shoots. He scores! Is Cason Gallant the player that Missouri State has been looking for, as Gallant will get the goal? Number 6 for him, breaking past and putting it through the legs of Kazablowski. And Missouri State here in the third period have an 8-3 advantage. Well, catch the call. From public address announcer Ryan Armstrong. And the
Ice
fans
Bears
are happy.
Goal scored by number 90, Cason Gallant. Assist on the play to number 74, Jacob Wheaton. Time of that goal, 8 minutes, 43 seconds of the third period. 90 assisted by 74. That's a Missouri State.
So the Ice Bears with Gallant second. Griffin makes a save. But Missouri State with the assist going to Wheatop on Gallant's goal, his 6th of the season and 2nd of the hockey game.
Huge goal there for the Ice Bears, as again the Lopes had pressure in their end, and if they'd have been able to put one in and make it 7-4, would have made things a little more interesting. But
now we're going to get a penalty as an Ice Bear is chopped down from behind. That yeah. is Shakes, I believe, as he draws the penalty.
High sticking call, looks like it's being indicated. Lopes pleading their case, but
It's a pretty obvious call there.
I don't know if we got that on replay or not. Going in the penalty box and not happy about it is Ruddick. It was a slash to the back. So the officials taking a look at this one. McGowan is there.
Grand Canyon, number 16, Justin Ruddick. 2 minutes, high sticking. Time of the penalty, 9:44 in the third period.
They call it high sticking. Wetop works it as Missouri State is on power play number 7, I believe, and it's immediately cleared. Sent all the way down. Nine penalties, 43 minutes for the Lopes. Frederick is there. Up high, but instead sends it to the far side. Now a high stick. Fans react to that. Here's Frederick to Gallant. Up and off of the stick of McGowan, but they get it to Frederick. Ooh. He's pushed from behind. Stay plays to Gallant. Meets McGowan with a drive and a save by Kazabowski.
Yeah, so, a bit of a check from behind there on Frederick, but I think he had kind of turned his body into that. I don't think it was malicious on the part of the Lopes, but it looked pretty gruesome at the time.
Well, here's the thing. You see that a lot, and I don't know exactly what the rule is on that.
Yeah, it's a hard one to call there, Judge McCall, and I think there was nothing
because
malicious
about it. You could hit a player from behind. Why can't you stick check him from behind and get called? Bratton drops it down low. Return pass. Raymer, right side, down the middle. He shoots. It's sent down in low again. Intercepted, though. Not cleared. Off the boards, finally it is, as Malthiner does the right thing, and he exits the zone. Ice Bears get it back in. Bratton, he's better now after hobbling off. Cross-ice pass, a dangerous one, and Potich is able to steal it. Protecting the play is Bratton. He gets slashed, penalty. Ice Bears get the goaltender off. Here's Brackbill, a delayed call, and the Ice Bears will have the advantage. Sent to the far side, it is now touched up by Dent. And a power play for Missouri State.
Another obvious call is the stick just slashed out of the hands there. And easy call for referee Carrere to make.
This one against Husby. Missouri State on power play number 8. Gallant to work. Down the middle. Frederick right side. Gallant left circle. Gallant shoots and trying to tip it in was McGowan. Couldn't do it. Frederick again centering it through. Broken up nicely by the stick of Murphy. And it's out to center and all the way down. 1:30 to go on the power play. Missouri State leads 8-3. Wetop around Murphy. Wetop still with it. Swiped away from him and out, and Gallant will chase. Case and Gallant. Gallant gets checked by Misek. And McGowan will reset.
Grand Canyon bench loving that one.
Here are the Ice Bears. They have a 3-on-3 into the zone to Brackbill. Dropping it down low to Ross. Working it up high to Malthiner. Cross ice. They get it to Raymer. Now to Bratton. He works it in low off of Brackbill's stick. Chased from him, hits a skate, goes to Bratton. Picks up the loose change. Now power play with 34 seconds. Ice Bears a little bit too heavy with it, but instead it stays in though. Good play by Raymer. He shoots and a save, and it's right in the midsection of Kazabowski, as right there was Brackbill on his doorstep.
Good job by Brackbill to get in front of the net and cause a screen in front of the goaltender, but Kazabowski able to pick that one up. Hangs onto it for no rebound. 25 seconds to go in the penalty here, and 6:30 remaining in the game.
Missouri State looking to go 6-2 on the season. Grand Canyon hoping to even their record. They are 1-2-1 coming into today's game. And they will finally be at home. It's been a 5-game road trip for the Lopes, as the power play has 5 seconds left. Puck is back out to center ice. Teams are at full strength. And I mentioned that the Lopes will finally be home in Tucson to Arizona and Arizona State. Delayed offside. Puck is cleared out. It's a 2-on-2. Billings to lead it for the Lopes. 5:39 to go. Working it is Wiedenbaum. Gets it to Schaefer. Billings with a drive, and he missed wide. And actually, I think they're only, yeah, they're home with University of Arizona and Colorado, I think, is who it is. Wiedenbaum is able to clear it out to center. So Lopes happy to be home after this weekend. Missouri State stays at home. Next weekend, Central Oklahoma. Here's Hintz. He shoots, and a glove save. The goaltender wants to play it quickly. Cummings, can he clear? No. But possession as Missouri State finishes their line change. 4:51. Shots 38-21. Here's Brackbill to Kelly through the slot. Donovan is able to clear. Raymer, two goals for him. One a power play affair. Sent all the way down. It is too far for Wojcicki, and Raymer will set things up for Missouri State. Past Brackbill's stick. Cleared off the stick of Schaefer, and he'll retrieve it himself. Schaefer gets double teamed with 4:10 to go. Puck in front of the Missouri State bench. Now worked into Kelly. He breaks free. Left side. Kelly in front. He shoots. Great glove save. We're going to get a penalty. Kelly draws a penalty. And is there a discussion on a potential penalty shot? No.
Looked like it was in the consideration there. It might have been a penalty shot.
Yeah, see if we can take a look at that one.
At this point in the game, I think Pereira content to just go with a 2-minute minor. Good job there by Kelly on that rush. He tried to open up the five hole, but the goaltender wasn't biting, and nothing to shoot at.
So it's going to be just a hooking call. Oh, slashing, I guess. And that will go against Cummings. So another power play. This is number 9 for Missouri State. Gallant carries it through. Flan, can he hold it on? Yes. Cody will keep it up high to Frederick. Now to Gallant. Gallant trying to work it. He sends it to Frederick right side. He shoots. Oh, a great glove save right through traffic. And Kazabowski able to make the save. So if we go back and take a look at just what a nice save that was through traffic. Flash in the leather there. 1:23 to go in the period with an 8-3 advantage for Missouri State. Gallant to keep it in. Centers it right through, save, and we top the chase, but it is not clear. Held in, and a shot by Frederick is gobbled up by Kazabowski.
Good pressure here by the Ice Bears on their power play as they continue to put pucks on net. Shots now showing 42-21 being doubled up by the Ice Bears.
Puck won and cleared and sent all the way down. 1 minute to go in the power play. Missouri State, who started off at 2-for-3 on the power play, has not gained a power play goal in a while. Here's Gallant. Carrying it all the way through. Gallant down low. Wietop calling for it is Raymer. Instead, it is Wietop who's going to have to knock it away from everybody. He does, and it's McGowan. But stepping in front of him and carrying the puck is Nate Moore. Moore out of Sioux Falls, South Dakota, has it taken away. Here comes Missouri State 2-on-2. Bratton, he gets upended. No penalty. Play continues. And Donovan off the boards. Brackbill almost stole. Schaefer for Grand Canyon. We're back to 5-on-5 now. And a shot comes in, a bouncing one that is held onto after getting the shot was Jared Bratton. Dan, I don't know if you can take a look at this, but that big pyramid that's going on in the corner there. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Well, okay, ignore the, there you go. Ignore the netting. But,
down it's coming now too, just on cue.
Well, there we go. they got their 2 seconds of fame. Here's Schaefer. He'll flip it in all the way down, and an icing will be called.
Well, not quite the offensive outburst that we saw yesterday, but still another solid 60 minutes of hockey here from the Ice Bears as they defeat the Grand Canyon Lopes for a second time and sweep this series. Set up a huge weekend next week, and as you mentioned, Steve, against Central Oklahoma.
Maltener with a drive that's partially blocked by Cummings with 1:22 to go. Up the middle, here's Witter with a drive off the side of the net. Hintz dropped down in low to Shakes into the corner. Shakes working hard. Maltener's there, but instead Witter will drop it low. Intercepted now, pushed is Schaefer against the glass. Shakes gets checked down, penalty.
Still a little physical, Beck.
And Donovan will go, and Shakes just needs to skate away. He's probably saying something in French, but... There's the check.
Body's still flying here late in this contest. And Pepper's still a bit hot.
Twelve penalties, 49 minutes. This is power play number 10 for Missouri State. Derek Smith to win the draw. Kelly will have it. And a drive in, Raymer, save, rebound, it's cleared. We're going to claim play with a high stick. So Missouri State will touch up. Puck played with a high stick. Face off will stay in the Missouri State zone.
And the pyramid is back. And I think it's even bigger than before.
It is. Interesting. Off the draw. Ice Bears will win the puck, and Smith will work it through. Now on the left side, Wojcicki stops up, centers it to Kelly. It's deflected behind the net. Here's Smith. Power play doesn't matter because the penalty or the period will expire before. Smith gets knocked away. A couple of Ice Bears fall down. Here's Petroto. He'll bring it in shorthanded with 11 seconds to go. Gets a drive off, and Griffin still not happy after he made the save, and Griffin gets involved. A couple of things I take out of this hockey game is the fact that, and that really was skating through with the leg. I don't blame Griffin on that one. The goaltender makes the save and you skate through with the leg like that. That's a dangerous play. And a slashing penalty has been called. It looks like against Sam Wiedenbaum. So Missouri State has a two-man advantage, but there's only 8.4 seconds left in the period. But in the recap, a couple of things I want to mention that I think Missouri State needs to work on.
Kind of fitting that this game would end with a two-man advantage. We've seen several of those tonight.
And Raymer fans on it. 3 seconds to go. That'll do it for the period. Missouri State with a win, 8-3. Shots on goal in the third period, 11 on Kasablowski for a three-period total of 44. And for Missouri State, just 6 on Matt Griffin, or a three-period total of 22. Missouri State 3-for-10 on the power play, but the Lopes were 0-for-9 on the power play. And we'll get everybody in on this conversation, but guys, a couple of things that I saw with Missouri State was, one, you know the game's a little out of hand, so keeping the penalties to a minimum. And I think the other thing is to not take the foot off the pedal. I think Missouri State did that in this game more than they did yesterday.
I would agree with you, Steve. As the players go into the boards and fell the pyramid, but I was thinking the same thing about yesterday. They really kept the foot on the gas and had a full 60 minutes of offensive firepower. This game, they built that early lead and just kind of coasted a bit more, so we'll see what that means going into the next weekend, where they're going to have to play a full 60 minutes and be on their toes all weekend long.
Dan, before we get your comments, I think Tommy Raymer is the player of the game, and they'll have an interview with him, I assume. And we'll get his interview, and then we'll get your thoughts, Dan, as they're taking a picture shot of the player of the game, Tommy Raymer.
Fans down here with Steak and Shake player of the game, number 25, Tommy Raymer. It was a big, big weekend for you, breaking into the first goal column for as a Missouri State Ice Bear and topping it off with two more tonight. Take us through the weekend.
Oh, it was a great weekend. Oh, we battled hard, got the sweep, felt good.
What's your thoughts here of you being a freshman here at Missouri State, of this being your second weekend of homestand? What did you think about this crowd?
Oh, I love it. You guys are great.
What are your thoughts moving in? Do we have a week off to celebrate this awesome sweep, and then we'll move to UCO at Pink Eyes?
Preparation for that starts Monday. We're going to get ready for it.
Well, thank you, sir, and have a great weekend.
Thank you.
All right, Tommy Raymer, the Steak and Shake player of the game. But, Dan, your thoughts on this game here?
I totally agree with you guys as far as Missouri State taking the foot off the gas a little bit, especially in that second period, but it's very easy to do when you have a lot more penalties than you did the night before. I don't have the numbers in front of me, but it's close to double digits for penalties for both sides, so it's just one of those things where you got to clean up the penalties a little bit, and hopefully the defense will come with it.
Yeah, as you heard, a week off for homecoming, and then Missouri State will have they have been the national champions before,
and University of Central Oklahoma, October 22nd and 23rd. And that will be our next broadcast. We'll have it for you right here on Web Sports Radio. Hopefully we have the same crew. That would be great. Would love it. That means Dan Dow, are you going to be here?
I actually think I might be out of town, so.
Oh, come on. Everything's more important than hockey.
We'll look into it. We'll look into it.
I'm just kidding. I know there's life outside of hockey, absolutely. But Missouri State, though, they do have a weekend off to take part in school life, and they will get to go to homecoming next weekend. I think it's the third year in a row we've done this, and I know the kids like it to be able to be off, and that's one thing that we're going to continue as kind of a tradition here at Missouri State. But the final score is 8-3. The Ice Bears win this game, and they sweep the series. They improved to 6-2 on the season, and the Grand Canyon University Lopes are now 2-3-1 this season as they finally get to head home and play in Arizona at the AZ Ice Arcadia. We'll hear from Jordan Valley Ice Park in Springfield, Missouri, the Stan Melton Ice Arena, Missouri State with the sweep again. Final score is 8-3. For Scott Lutzke on graphics, for Dan Dow on camera, for Kurt Bussin, my color commentator, I'm Steve Kasson. Thanks for joining us. Until a couple of weeks from now, we bid you a good night.
You've been listening to Missouri State Ice Bears Hockey with your host, Steve Kasson. Thank you for tuning in to tonight's game. Ice Bears Hockey is a presentation of DS Sports Enterprises and WebSportsRadio.com.